don't know why I'm in such a great mood.
You just happy to be out the house, nigga.
Or it's nighttime and you're out the house, too?
This nigga like a cat after they take a shit. Nah. Cat be bouncing all over the fucking place.
Nah, because Sin already tried to trick me talking about something. Because I got Revolt all day tomorrow, and then I fly out, right? I fly to L.A. So she called before the podcast. I'm out. Make sure you come straight home afterwards so you can spend time with Lex.
I should try to use your child.
Oh, my God. So you can spend time with Lex. Talk about it, Quinn.
All right now, let me get in my shit.
Whoa, guess who was outside for this one?
Some of y'all wasn't outside for this one. Some of y'all wasn't. Hey, and let me just say, let me wait till the beat drop first, though. Salutations, greetings to everybody out there. Who's ready for a fucking podcast, huh? Yeah, I like the energy in the room right now.
Okay.
I like the energy in the room right now. I like niggas' game faces. We ain't even got no beef. We just got game faces. Game Let's talk faces. About it. A few things. He smoked this.
Super.
We can all say he smoked this, right?
Absolutely.
He got people saying he's the top 10 MCs ever.
We're going to talk about that. That's crazy. See, now I got to cut it off now that you said that.
Why?
Because that's, come on. Because that's true.
Yeah.
He came out with that shit.
I mean, Barry Sanders didn't play that long.
Come on. Knock it off. Don't do that, Roy.
But he didn't have 15 more of those, though.
he did. He put out Exhibit D, A.
Those were all good.
X.
Shiny Suit Theory. That was good.
L.
The whole Spotless Mind soundtrack remix album that he did.
And he just dropped the album the other day.
Yeah, he did. With all those songs.
With all those songs.
Small Hayden.
No.
And also, let me say, we caught a little bit of flack. We caught a little
As
bit
usual.
Of...
As usual.
Well, yeah, we caught a lot of flack. But we caught a little bit of flack up here when a couple of niggas sent some smoke my way saying, hey, all y'all just said Royce was going to... Like, y'all just agreed rather quickly that Royce was going to, like, end J-Elec.
Who was flacking that?
A lot of people in my mentions. Really? He's like, yo, what the fuck is wrong with y'all?
A few people flacked it.
They flacked Royce beating Jay?
J-Elec,
I'm just
yeah.
going with experience in that arena. That's why I picked Royce so quickly. Not to say that Jay Electronic is a great rapper.
Yeah,
nobody's saying that.
I think people
He's
just...
a top-tier rapper.
I just think people think when we say another rapper can... rap better than this person, or they just think that way. Yeah, like the other person can't rap at all.
I mean, the main thing is just more evidence. Like, yeah, we don't really have a lot of evidence of Jay's.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
And I think he's just like a really nice guy.
No,
on top of all of that.
And let me add to that when we be having these conversations about rap beef, for me, who can rap better never factors into it.
Right.
No, it's about.
That never
rap
factors
beef.
Into it for me. Like. Mm. Again, I've been saying it, but some of the best rap niggas, just some of the best war niggas, are not the best rappers.
Right.
So, but I stand by Royce killing J-Elec. let me be perfectly clear in that, and I fuck with J-Elec.
Yeah, but we just said
Royce is a killer.
Yeah,
I've seen him kill. Yeah. Now, welcome back to the Joe Budden Podcast, episode 181.
think you're right there. Yeah.
I like this whole two episodes a week thing where the number shoots up rather quickly. Helps me to remember things.
Okay.
Niggas call me phony because I'm remembering the numbers now that we got the Spotify thing going on.
I mean, you phony for other reasons. I wouldn't say for that.
Yeah, but they added that to the...
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm kind of with them.
The list,
I'll take it. 181. Memory's working rather fine. The Joe Budden Podcast here with a few of my nearest and dearest friends, Maul, Parks, Rory, Savon, and Erickson. How is everyone doing? What's the temperature in the room?
70...
It's pretty cool.
I feel good.
Do the young people? I'm not even playing with y'all today. I don't care about none of y'all got to say today. Do the young people know about how well versed do you think the young people are on temp checks?
Not very well versed.
Yeah,
at all.
Clearly with their antics.
Rory,
am I speaking for the young kids?
Yeah, you're young.
You know, it's fucked
up.
No, I
don't think our generation really understands temperature checks.
I go to Rory
and
for the
and
young
when someone
people.
Yeah, he's a young.
Is checking to see if there's an issue. I don't think they realize it. Mainly because a lot of issues don't really get there anymore.
No, I see temp checks rather often. Recently.
More gun violence than just temp checks as men.
It's a pretty quick way to check a temperature.
Well, I don't even think they was checking the temperature.
Yeah, that's not checking it. If you pull a gun out, the temperature is at maximum capacity.
Yeah,
my generation's not really good at seeing what's up. Like, let me figure out what you're really talking about right now. Hmm. Nah, I don't really get there. It's either 0 or 100 with my generation. There's no middle ground.
Okay.
Yeah, that was the bad thing about that Drake song. Because 0 to 100, like, everybody was dancing, but that's not a good thing.
Like, right. Sometimes it's like, hold on. Wait.
Sometimes you gotta be at like 47 just for a second.
It's like, my nigga, I ain't even come out the house for all this.
Yeah, let's think this through.
Relax.
Yeah, I guess we're gonna talk a lot about temp checks today. So where do you guys wanna start? I'm scared to ask.
Kanye did a little bit of a temperature check.
He did.
With
temp
a few
check,
people.
Temp check number one. See? We're gonna talk a lot about it.
Was that a temp check though?
You fucking right. Yeah. It was a temp check.
It was a roll. It's part of a rollout, but it was definitely a temp check.
The rollout.
Yo,
temp check is crazy.
Cheapening that? Are we cheapening that line? Are we responsible for cheapening like the rollout?
Yeah, I think we
Absolutely,
are a little bit.
Yeah.
That's definitely our fault. Sorry, guys.
Yeah,
but I will. All right, he just put out announcements for albums. He's talking again. He's back out of a sunken place, which he said 3 times that he's been out of this place. Mm. So I'm not sure when I should believe he's actually out of it.
Why don't we tell the people what we're talking about?
Kanye West was walking down a Chicago street.
They know exactly what we're talking about.
with a train above him. Telling
Rory
Nick Cannon,
just get right into his bag. Like some people missed it.
You know, but you know what I hate the most about that video with Kanye, that little clip. It's like this back home shit is like he's walking under the L. Like it's like, fam, you not in the hood walking under the train station. Nah. Like stop it. That's
well,
not
he kept
the
camera real close to his face. We didn't really see his surroundings besides the train above.
Trust me, that's the nice area.
You know what's funny? I thought I was the only one sitting there like a dumbass looking at the train tracks.
Yeah,
like you're artsy.
I was like, look at this guy. He's in Chicago. Yeah.
Even his temp checks are artsy.
There's a train.
Mm-hmm. There's production value.
Nice shape up.
Mm-hmm.
I was into it.
I
was into it a little bit. First, let me say that the Kanye topic is becoming redundant to me. I'm sick of talking about him. not because I'm angry at him or upset at him, like people assume. And people think that we all phony because we all have the same stance on Kanye and him.
Yeah. Well, I mean, come on. You know, we're just a bunch of yes men with no opinions.
That's a new narrative, true. Though. Yeah. That's a new one.
That's why I ignore it, because I know it's the furthest thing from true. Like, if you've listened to 181 episodes, all we do is argue with each other.
No, that's how I know we popping.
Just because Joe had a personal issue with M, and we just let him get that issue off, we became yes men.
Right.
Personal issue, Mom was there for all that shit. Parks was there, too. Yeah, it was my issue, but niggas was there. But anyway, I'm tired of talking about him too. So let's get back to the other nigga I'm tired of talking about.
Sprinkling some Drake while we're at
other
it.
Nigga, yeah.
Yo, for real, because I'm so psycho and a narcissist and all this other shit. I think that these niggas be doing this shit just for the news cycle now.
Of course. It's all marketing. All promotion.
That's been going on for a couple years.
Yeah.
So yeah, I think he's still harping on this Pusha T Drake thing. Which all of us are over and don't give a fuck about anymore.
We have us, right? See, y'all be clowning me sometimes, but one of the great things about this podcast is we just like to speculate and predict. So this shit that he addressing, we've been on 8 months ago. However many, I'm exaggerating, but we've been on this for a while now.
And it's to the point we don't care about the truth.
Yeah, like.
But it's also another thing too. Is like, yo, fam, I never thought for 1 second he was talking about Kim when he said Kiki. I never thought that was directed towards
Neither
Kim Kardashian. Not one time have I thought that. No. So it's like you saying stuff, and it's like, what are you talking? Nobody, I don't even think nobody ever thought that until you just said that.
Like six people on Twitter did.
The tweet was going around where Kim said her name was Kiki or nickname or whatever, you know, whatever
it was.
Who
knew that?
Drake, apparently.
I don't know. I don't know.
Stop it, man. Like, we just got to not. Remember when Kanye didn't have a phone?
Yeah, dude.
Niggas had to email Kanye.
Yeah, he just had emails. Yeah, then he never had a phone.
Oh, man, we need
when
that.
Phones were pretty accessible.
Yeah, we need to go back to that Kanye. We need a no phone Kanye.
Email Kanye.
Email Kanye might have been the best.
He was great.
Yeah.
So Kanye does acknowledge that he was in a sunken place.
He did before the Trump thing, and then the Trump thing happened. He's done this a couple times.
And he said he was trolling. He said
and
the
used
Trump
those
thing,
exact
wearing
words.
Wearing the MAGA hat was him trolling. That's what he said. He
I don't
said,
think that's a funny troll.
He said, nobody can't out-troll me. I put the MAGA hat on, like. That's what he said.
Listen, guys, and this is just my opinion. I don't think you should strive to be the biggest troll. I don't really think that's an accomplishment.
Yeah, Kanye too old. Kanye too old to try to be the biggest troll, man.
Yeah, you've done too much.
Two kids, you've accomplished
too much
three
in
kids.
The world to put on a MAGA hat like, for a troll.
Yeah, it's like, come on, relax.
All right, well, what did you guys think about the temperature check? Should he have told Nick Cannon to stop talking about my fucking wife?
I mean, you could always listen. I respect that part. If you want to tell dudes to stop talking about your wife. That I respect. And
I'm
understand.
Sick of that.
But
no, I'm tired of that too. I am.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be honest. Yeah, I'm tired of that one.
What? Don't talk about my wife.
Yeah, I'm sick of it.
Why? I agree though. As men, don't put wife and kids into.
Well, fam. If he said something disrespectful, yeah, of course.
Yo, you niggas gotta relax.
But
man.
I don't think Nick ever said anything.
All right, wow. He said something about your wife. Now what?
Temperature check.
Yeah, you
temperature check.
You.
So if you say it again, I'm gonna run in your mouth.
No, you're not.
That's what he's alluding to.
I don't like this new thing of, I feel like certain rules and certain guidelines and certain boundaries used to just be by default. Mm-hmm. Like, it was by code that you just knew these things. And the people that didn't know these things were outsiders. Right? You follow me so
I
far?
I agree. And yeah, I still think some of those are around and striving. I think wife is off limits, though. I think kids are off limits too.
Okay, so let me finish making my point first.
Well, outside of rap,
because
Adams, that's
because
fine.
That is my
you're
point.
Rapping.
That's one of those. Don't talk about my wife. Don't talk about my kid. Yet yeah. We have this streak of men proclaiming this shit like it's written in like it's the gospel somewhere. No, nigga, we know that. If the nigga is saying something about your wife anyway, then y'all got to go have another conversation now.
Yeah, away from social media.
But this is like. Who's like a lot of people are doing this now. All right, Kanye saying this, Bush is saying this. Who else said? A bunch of niggas said this.
Yeah, I mean that's usually the no women, no kids rule is usually in effect when you know men are dealing with each other. Usually don't go that route, and I understand it. But my thing is,
oh M with don't talk about my daughter. Hey,
yeah,
like,
I mean,
man, all you niggas shut up.
But dudes usually go to that. That's,
shut the
that's,
fuck
that's
up.
That's the sensitive button for most men. Don't talk about my wife. Don't talk about
that's,
my
yeah,
kid.
That's the line crosser.
Yeah, and I understand it. I understand. That's right up there with inviting a man to your private parts. That's to me, that's like the,
no,
on the same list.
That's correct. Mm-hmm. Don't think that me telling people to shut the fuck up is saying that. I disagree with that.
Right.
All of these rules are in effect. Mm-hmm. However, if you play by the rules, you got to play by the rules. So when MGK said, Eminem, you've been fucking shitting on everybody your whole career.
This is true.
And now I say one little thing about your daughter, and I certainly didn't mean to disrespect her because I have a daughter.
Right.
Now we hitting the sensitive button? No, get the fuck out of here.
No,
bye.
I agree.
Bye.
If you play
I've
that
been
game,
in, I've been in
no, sensitive bullies.
I've been
I get
in
it.
Rap war with niggas, and they went right to the kid. Guess what? You got to eat that.
Yeah.
Or go shoot him in his head.
Well, do you think there's a difference? Because in rap battles, we have seen it go there, and we always say there's no rules in rap battles. But if you're in an interview talking about somebody's child, is that different than rapping about it?
Yo, let me say this loud and clear. Let me say this loud and clear for everybody listening.
pardon me, gentlemen. Let me say this loud and clear for everybody listening. All of these rapper niggas are nice guys. They're all nice, caring, sweet gentlemen. All of them. Every last one. So what is all this? They all know they shouldn't say nothing bad about your kid, do nothing bad. Like, what are we doing? What are we saying?
No, yeah, we,
niggas is all 40 and up.
Right. Side note, where do dogs fit in the list of things you can't talk about?
Chill, that's over the line for me.
Yeah.
Are we going to get into that
we're
now?
We're going to get there. No.
Yeah. Let's yeah, save that.
That was a bit too much for me. I took that perk. I wrote some bars last night. I'm just letting y'all know that. I'm ready whenever you're ready.
Well, you
ready
saw
for what?
Whatever. As soon as you hit record, I'm ready.
All right. No, I want to get into what my nigga Nick be talking about. First of all, Nick is where do you guys stand on Nick Cannon? Pause.
I like Nick.
I like Nick is.
I think he does a lot of great things.
He's one of the
keeps
most
a check.
He's one of the most underrated people I think in our culture. Honestly.
Huh. Think he does a lot of good for people. Puts a lot of people on.
Yeah, I truly believe he's one of the most, because he's not quote unquote looked at as one of the cooler guys in the industry, but he's done a lot, he's accomplished a lot, and he has his hands in different areas that a lot of people don't even know about.
Also high on that sniper list.
Oh,
so you can't call
I mean,
him.
I think everybody know about that.
No, that, I don't think they do.
I think, and that's it. I don't think, you know what I'm saying? And a couple of movies that we kind of look at in our culture, like, that was trash.
You know what? This is a good time for me
but
to play this.
But a chill would love don't cost a thing.
For me to play this clip, because y'all are right.
I forgot Christina, your girl was in.
So, yeah, you better relax.
I guess this is the way we communicate now in 2018 via social media. We don't use phones and stuff like
you
that.
You know that, Nick.
But just saying.
You know we don't call
Kanye,
people.
That 200 episode of Wildin' Out is upon us.
See, gotta
second
plug
record,
your shit.
Record
He's
breaker,
a gangster.
Sold out that Toyota Center right
I fuck with Nick.
Tonight, again in Houston.
That was a stunt line.
You're more than welcome.
Sold out
Let's
the
talk
Toyota
about
Center.
It, man.
He
come
stunted.
On the show. Show that it's all love.
Then
man.
Invited
like,
him.
I say nothing disrespectful, but
that's a stunt.
We can have a good time with this. You know what I'm saying?
On my shit.
It could be Mariah jokes, Kim jokes.
That is a stunt.
All that. You done came into
that
the
is a major stunt. That line reminded me that he's a sniper.
Yeah.
He could say that to him.
In all seriousness, man, I got nothing but love for you, but you know,
I love
I'm
you.
Always speak my mind, just like you always.
Gotta start
speak
with
yours.
Love, but I'll fuck you up.
Not you, not
he just
NBC,
said that.
Not no corporate infrastructures. No one is.
That was a stunt.
Infrastructure is a stunt. Just that word.
Yeah, whenever you use infrastructure when you're directing your comments towards a man. No infrastructure.
That was, he ended with the biggest stunt, and I think that's what kind of got a lot of the quote-unquote whack juice off of Nick Cannon, but it wasn't very publicized. His move with NBC was big.
Yeah. Yeah.
The culture really didn't focus on it because of however they feel about Nick Cannon, mm-hmm. but Nick Cannon had a deal with NBC. Then on his Netflix special, he said a joke about NBC standing for nothing but colored anything. I don't remember the joke, and I'm freestyling right now. But he walked away from that deal. Mm. So when he drops that there, and then he reminds you about Mariah and every other yeah, Nick.
No, I agree.
He's
one of the few people that puts to action those words of like sticking together, putting people on, doing things that make sense for our culture, etc. Mm. Nick does those things.
Yeah.
He doesn't just talk about them in interviews and on Twitter. He acts.
Yeah. I agree. Yeah,
word conceded ain't battled in 20 years.
Yeah, conceded. He retired without announcing it.
Hitman came back, caught a body and boogied again.
Yeah.
These niggas was out.
Shit, go
sold out arenas.
Go look at that early Wildin' Out shit. D-Ray, Kevin Hart, Cat Williams. That dude Mikey Day that's on SNL now.
Damn, like, slow down like with all
put,
of your.
He put a lot of comedians on from that show.
Yeah.
All
did.
Right. Well, let's crack on you a little bit. Slow down with the names. He just rap.
Let's crack on you a little bit. Like you got your name. Your name belt heavy.
God
yeah.
forbid I remember who was on the show.
He rattled them off.
He
I can't rattle
off.
Out here.
You're
no.
God damn. Not the Wildin' Out name.
What was I saying about Nick Cannon? Oh, so that leads me to my question. So who wins the fight? If Nick Cannon and Kanye square up.
I think Nick is in shape, man.
Oh, Nick. For sure. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Kanye just came out the sunken place. His legs ain't ready.
Well, I was about to say.
He ain't done leg day
in
years.
His legs is, still wobbly from the sunken. Once you come out the sunken, your legs are still like Bambi, you know, when Bambi was
gotta learn to walk again.
Yeah,
I don't think
Nick, Bambi legs.
I don't think Nick wants smoke with Sunken Place.
Yeah, I
no
think
with
he do.
Sunken Place. Yeah,
Because I think Nick quietly was, he peeked into the sunken place. So he saw what it was. And then he made a strong U-turn and got out of it. Like, they almost had him. They almost had Nick. Yeah, they almost had him. And he was like, nah, fam.
And you.
They never had me. They never almost had me.
Like, when was Maul almost in the sunken place?
The toast.
The toast.
Oh, shit.
Shut up, nigga.
What?
I was never almost
yes,
in the
you
sunken
place. Yes, you was. Nigga, the podcast saved you.
How many times you been to Calabasas?
I was never almost in those sunken places.
The podcast didn't save you from the sunken place. Tell the truth.
Almost in those sunken
places. Calabasas might be the sunken
think
place.
Think about it. That's where he was at when he came. No, and we ain't ask him to stay.
No, Calabasas is not a sunken place.
You see Drake moving back to Toronto?
He's from there.
Fam.
Just saying. None of them is from Calabasas.
Let me tell you something.
Who's from Calabasas?
When Drake moved to Toronto, Joe's moving in Toronto. I'm moving in that house.
I mean, we know you want to see his bathroom.
No, I've seen the bathroom. It's beautiful.
It's beautiful.
They got a wine cellar in the bathroom.
That is swag, though.
I told y'all I DM'd his realtor.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, you did something.
Did I tell you that?
No.
You see, he put out them little trailers for the progress of the house.
Yeah, he's showing it from the
Drake did?
Yes.
Wow. I know, he making it hot.
He got pics from the drone.
I was so mad. Like, nigga, stop posting pics of your house. I'm going to be in there.
I missed it.
That's a fucking
Yo, you need help, man.
Yeah, you do.
Man, that's a big house.
He won't even know you in there.
That's a nice fucking. How much is that house? Oh, he said $30
million.
That's it. Joe, IG Live.
You get a lot for $30 million. In Toronto, I guess.
I hope so.
In Toronto. You don't get nothing.
You could get that if for $30 million in Texas.
No, you get a lot more than that for $30 million in Texas.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
You could buy Texas.
You might get Texas.
You might get Texas. It's all yours. We're out.
We're out.
We're out. Oh, the whole state. We're out.
$30 million don't get you very much up here.
No,
I'd be on YouTube AirPlay, looking on the screen at the cribs.
$30 million get your apartment on Park Avenue.
Yeah, yeah.
And you got a
one bedroom.
And it's small.
And it's rent. You can't even buy it.
And you can't pay $30 million
rent. $30 million to rent.
That's what you're paying. Can't even buy that shit.
All right. So all y'all got Nick winning the fight. I got Sunken Place. Kanye winning the fight.
Yeah, I'm going with Nick.
But he's out the Sunken Place, so he would lose.
He's out the Sunken. Yeah, he is out the Sunken Place. Time to sell. Got sneakers coming. Albums coming.
Wait. You on that still?
Look at it. We seeing it. It's clear as day now.
What are y'all thoughts on? Oh, okay. I got two fucking Rock Nation title Rockefeller insiders with me in Mal and Rory. Rory took a pic with Hove, so I know you've got some insider info for me.
Not telling you.
Damn, what?
Trying to get a second picture.
The throne. Yeah, you and B-Dot. The throne too.
What about it?
Give it to me, fellas.
I'm still saying that shit ain't happening. Hove read that
it's
with the rest
happening.
Of us on Twitter.
It's not happening.
Yeah, it's not even happening. Though Beyonce had on the Yeezy 2s.
That was confirmed that they were not the Yeezys.
They didn't look like Yeezys either.
They were some other brand.
Listen, man.
Well, why did Kanye think they were Yeezys?
Because he's in. Are you listening to what I'm telling you? That Savon, nigga is fresh
Savon,
out the sunken.
Savon ain't doing shit but texting chicks.
Can
you fucking fact check some of this shit so we can stop sounding stupid?
When you fresh out
Savon,
the sunken,
that text
nigga?
Like, yeah, you know,
we need
at
a
the
new,
podcast
yeah,
right now.
Yeah. We definitely need a no phone at the podcast rule.
Who the fuck is he texting?
When you fresh out
thought
the sunken.
Thought you was married. The timestamps. Yeah, this nigga.
I'm doing the timestamps.
The timestamps. Is that what he says?
Yeah, Ma, I'll have them shout you out on the podcast today.
Erickson, are you in a relationship?
Yeah, he said no.
I didn't like that tone.
I'm trying to fucking talk to men to see who else is having problems at home. Like, because of work.
Because of work.
Rory said, like, Sam is a rider. She won't beef with this nigga about shit. This is just me beefing.
Just you, bro.
Park's chilling. He ain't seen his girl in a year.
Yeah. I see my girl all the time.
See?
See? I find time for my baby, all right?
Whoa.
Oh, that's so easy to say when you don't live together. Yo, niggas that don't live with their girl,
it's
they be
different.
Talking so much shit.
Yo, living with your girl is different.
That's
man.
Scary.
It's different.
Yeah, those are definitely not Yeezys, by the way.
Yeah.
Those are Pumas.
Oh, those are the Yeezy Pumas.
Yeah, they're the five mules. Come on, you buy designer shit now. You should know.
No, I don't. Clay be doing that shit.
You be wearing it though.
Yeah, I do.
All right. Well, yeah, they're the five mules.
Oh, duh.
How did y'all not know that?
The five
How
mules.
Do we not know that? Never, man. The Yeezy 2s.
So there's really no Throne 2. Now I'm sad.
Man, I tried to tell y'all that. That shit ain't no... No, what's a Throne 2 happening?
I was ready to be phony. But, I was going to be like, damn, if Hov welcomes him, so will I.
Man. Damn it. That, Jay will not be on that
Throne. He's so corny, but I would think the same thing, so I can't even say shit.
Because that's his man.
Yeah, it's not happening, bro.
Listen, Rhymefest welcomed him back.
That's a fact.
After all the Donda's House madness.
Yeah, but Rhymefest... Listen, man, the people that are welcoming Ye back so open, they need him back. Jay don't need no Kanye.
Rhymefest was pretty critical of him.
Yeah, but he welcomed him back, though. He could use that cosign right now.
Listen, man.
He could use a few flicks next to Ye right now.
That nigga told Drake he don't care if they never talk again. He care. He cares.
Of course he does.
He saw Meek Mill and Drake playing ping pong and was sad. I'm really good at ping pong. I'm good too.
Big sad. Oh, Ye wanted to play ping pong too.
He did. Big sad. Y'all stupid.
You don't think he was big sad?
He's definitely big sad.
He is big sad.
Yo, somebody told me that Georgia Smith always looks sleepy and I can't unsee it now.
What's wrong with you, man?
That's her image.
So image, the sleepy look?
Yeah.
The bedroom eyes?
She
got the bedroom eyes all the time?
No, the bedroom eyes is different from looking like you need a nap.
No, that's true. That's true. When you're sleepy, it's a whole different look.
Yeah, she be having a little nappish look in her face, like she could use a quick 30.
I mean, she's working hard.
She's looking like she smoked, right? She smoked. Yeah, I think that's probably that high face, that high look. Hmm. She definitely smokes.
Yeah, British weed makes your eyes look a little different.
It's a little different, yeah. That weed over there.
Yo. That's that London fog.
It's a little different, man.
Yo, these Saturday podcasts are nuts.
Yeah, that's how it go.
I wonder, have I ever smoked some British weed?
Definitely.
Some British weed.
That was the last show
we
did.
That just sounds weird.
Was in fucking England. And we definitely baked out that little tiny green room.
England.
I forgot what that shit was called. The venue.
I was nuts.
The sound was bad. Like,
how was the weed? Shows too.
The weed was. I was high.
Okay,
but my eyes were a little different than right,
the. Shout out to the London Bridge.
I was high.
British weed.
Shout out to that bloke grade.
Right. All right. So wait. Well, how do we just don't talk about weed? What the fuck? You brought up
Georgia Smith, and I said all right, she probably.
I didn't really want to talk about Georgia Smith. What else are we? Y'all got Drake's poor little friend. Y'all got Drake's poor little 14-year-old friend.
Well, from Stranger Things,
putting out whole paragraphs about their friendship. Why don't y'all leave? I told y'all that Drake don't deserve a nasty award. What the fuck is wrong? Why don't y'all listen to us on this podcast?
This podcast is so phony. Maybe we did sell out.
No, not yet. Why is my son right there?
I have no idea.
Oh shit! That's what I wanted to talk to y'all about before we get too far away.
What's that?
And I really didn't want to touch this too much here. So I'm not going to touch it too much here because I really want to talk about this with Remy and Deani and them. But we got to talk about August Alsina just for a little bit.
What's up?
What August did?
Yeah, has he put out music lately?
Oh, see, y'all don't know.
I don't know.
Oh, man, this is great.
Enlighten us.
All right. Well, we just had that whole conversation about the do's and don'ts of speaking about people's wives and girlfriends and partners and significant others, right?
Why is George Smith over there looking hot? Yeah. So you've all got her right up there on the laptop. It's distracting.
Yeah, she do look high as shit.
No, she's tired. She's fucking sleepy over there. Fucking sleepy face.
I know high Visine eyes when I see it. She high with the clear eyes.
Yeah, she's high for sure right there.
Oh, all right. Jada Pinkett Smith's birthday was recently, I think.
Yeah, a couple of days ago.
Happy belated, Jada.
Happy belated. Because
I know you're listening right now.
Happy belated to Jada Pinkett Smith. You know, you say that, but you know, we have no idea who's listening. There's a lot of corporate people out there listening.
Think Will's listening?
Will hears everything.
He'll hear it soon.
Jaden is in touch with the culture.
If he's not listening to this one, something tells me he'll hear some in the future.
Will hears everything. Once you play a movie like I Am Legend, your senses is just like you hear everything. You hear shit that's not there.
Didn't he die in I Am Legend?
Did he die?
Well, there was like six different endings.
Never saw it. Don't ruin it.
Yeah, there was like seven.
Who didn't see I Am Legend by now?
Yeah, you trash.
You ain't see it by now, good. Like, you just don't deserve to see it. Yeah, like, shut up.
August Alsina posted like a happy birthday Instagram post, and the video was him and Jada Pinkett Smith walking through the grass, and the caption.
Well, hold before you start. Jada definitely strikes me as someone that loves to walk through the grass.
No, that's
so
cool.
So far I'm on board.
Listen, the grass is dope.
Yeah, I love the grass.
Yeah, especially walking in it barefoot.
Yeah, or laying.
It's great.
Yeah, all of that's fine. But the caption says, and it says, and I quote, "I don't believe in luck. I believe in God's divine order. And you are an example of God's divinity, and it's covering over my life. A beautifully complex individual you are. I could spend a lifetime decoding you. Thank you for your laughter. Thank you for seeing my heart and character and not measuring me based upon what I come from. You see me for who I am and what I'm going to be, even when I can't see me. Thank you for challenging me on a daily basis. You're a little piece of heaven here on earth, the fortune in my cookie, the vet to my rookie. You are love personified. There hasn't been enough diction created to articulate or express the capacity of my love for you. It is simply beyond measure and human comprehension. So as my soul continues this quest, I would just like to say, happy birthday, Bess. You are nothing like the rest."
She said that to him or he said that to her?
He said that to her.
And to Jada Pinkett Smith?
We're about to fuck him up.
We're going
to
beat the dog shit out of...
I mean, I think he saw the Tupac movie and saw that the poem worked for Tupac.
My nigga, listen.
Maybe got on his poem swag.
Listen, let me explain something. Will gonna beat the shit out of him. Chelsea. You are the vet to my rookie.
I missed that.
The fortune in my cookie.
The fortune.
If a nigga tell my wife she's the fortune in his cookie, I'm gonna break your fucking cookies.
That'll be the last fortune cookie you have, buddy.
I have a fortune for you.
Yeah, I'll crack your fucking cookie open, nigga.
Why is August Alsina telling her these things? Like, what's up with him?
That's
maybe his own spirit.
Y'all don't. That's not creepy.
No, that was definitely
that's
a little.
Creepy.
That was.
I when did they start hanging out?
It's a little uncomfortable. I'm not gonna say it was creepy. It's a little uncomfortable though. I'm not gonna say creepy.
Did she respond?
It's uncomfortable.
I haven't seen a response.
She didn't comment. Thanks.
Okay. She's not the person I want to hear a response from. I need to hear something from Will now.
Oh, his next clip is gonna be it.
But Will gonna have gonna have the most positive threats you could ever hear.
Yeah, because Will is a positive person. He's not gonna be wilding.
Will.
Although I would like to see him respond from like Ishka Bibbles eating a cheesesteak. Like, yo, you got this fucked up, youngin. you got this.
I'm
twisted.
About to be the cheese to your steak, motherfucker. Yeah.
Right.
I don't want to see Will on a boat on an island somewhere. I don't want to see him on a mountain doing none of that fancy rich nigga shit he be doing.
Ishkabibbles.
Yeah, he got an answer for this.
I mean, absolutely. Maybe August thinking you got beat up in your hometown, got ran out to Fresh Prince, Bel Air. So.
They're not related or anything, right? Like, we might not. I hope we're not like twisted. They're cousins or something. Like, we get this shit all fucked up.
And if they are, that's now we've been in the creepy zone.
We've been in the creepy zone.
That's uncomfortable. But creepy is they're related.
Damn,
but,
man. I don't think it's working.
I know that Will and Jada are more mature than us. I understand.
No. I'm just saying it's only not creepy because August is an adult. He's of age. It's not
my fist is an adult.
Yeah, but that's why it's not creepy. It's uncomfortable though. It's like
my
man,
open hand
about?
Is an adult.
Absolutely, I get it. Go to Ishka. Well,
listen, Sin birthday coming up. So
what does that mean? What does that even mean?
I'll be waiting. I'll be waiting to see the little caption.
Okay. You'll be in a tagged portion of her Instagram.
Let's see where you going with
it. Yeah, listen,
camped bro, out.
Go ahead and play with me.
Yeah. The vet to my rookie.
The fortune to my cookie.
The fuck out of here, August Alsina.
Don't ever talk about your cookie again.
Why do you have cookies? Yeah,
and why do you have fortune?
Why do you have fortune cookies? That's you a weird nigga. Who has that in the stash besides Bruce Leroy? All right, that's all I have for August. I want to talk about this with women. That I don't really want to talk about this with you guys.
Yeah, that's better.
Yeah, 100%.
The women have very diluted interpretations of these type of things. That's gonna
be they think, what was wrong with
he's
that?
He's really nice. Oh, yeah. He's like my best friend.
They're besties.
That's definitely like a brother response.
He would never do anything.
Yeah, I ain't gonna lie.
Why do we put them voices on women?
That's how they sound. I don't know any woman that sounds like that, honestly.
What?
You don't get out much.
Shut up. That's how it all like sounds after a while, Mal.
Yeah. Now, you might be right.
You're in a relationship.
I'll be just watching the game.
It's called Word. That's crazy.
I saw you here in the background.
Hey, sound like the teacher in Charlie Brown after a while.
Come on, man, shut up.
All right, what are we doing, man? Come on, give it to me.
How bizarre.
I mean, okay, listen. How bizarre. Let's just talk about something real quick. What's wrong with Bizarre, man? No, seriously.
He's bizarre.
Yo, Mal always say, yo, seriously.
No, seriously. Because nah,
why is that funny to me?
Nah, because I'm telling you, y'all look at shit and, you know, we laugh, we be silly, but I look at shit too and I be like, yo, there's something wrong here. Like, this is something really awkward about this.
Did
like,
he used to wear a diaper?
And he wore a shower
this
cap.
This nigga Mal does not want to use the word creepy. It's creepy, no, man.
It's past. This is past creepy. This is like, fam, you need some help. Like, this is like, what are you? First of all, why is he even coming at you? I don't even understand. Like, why he
riding for his man?
Nobody said
that's it.
Plain and simple.
Yo, but when the last time
so that was your job.
M ain't spoken.
Shoot my dog. I'm gonna take your
gun. No, we gotta stop just saying niggas is niggas, man.
Why
dude?
Only in hip hop?
Yo, if I don't see you in 5 years, you not my man's.
Yeah.
If I don't speak to you, like, you don't know what's going on in my life right now. Like, are you not my man's? We gotta stop saying just because a nigga did a couple records with each other and niggas ain't man's like that.
I don't even like the dudes. Yeah, I judge dudes on their criteria for my mans.
Yeah, like, that ain't my mans.
Why is everybody a mans?
Just because you're from Detroit don't mean you Eminem's mans, B. Let's just put that out there.
Bizarre.
I'm sure for years that was the case, though. Yeah.
Bizarre.
Things change.
This record is because he's trying to be the man. He's trying to be his man.
No, that's what I'm saying. People are trying to be his mans.
Yo, but it's...
So you didn't like the record?
Bizarre, angry.
You wasn't feeling it?
Hell no.
What about the video?
The video is the most disturbing thing to me.
Y'all watched the vid?
Yeah, I was about to say, I didn't see the video.
I didn't know where to find the audio for that record.
I'm not going to Audio Mac.
I'm not going to
Bizarre. I have YouTube Premium. I close my phone.
You type
and
Bizarre
just
into your fucking Google.
That record,
too?
That shit is definitely not on, that's not on Spotify. Guaranteed.
How Bizarre.
It won't be after today, buddy.
Beef different over here. Can't even get your record.
Wait, he ever beef different? Beef different. Shut up. I have nothing to say about Bizarre.
It's just like, come on, man. Like, certain shit is just like, all right, enough is enough. Stop.
Listen, it was whatever. I didn't care about the shit he said about Joe, but you bring up Harlem and Brooklyn.
It's true. I got a problem with that.
I have an issue now.
You can't start talking about the dogs. You can talk about my mama. You can talk about whoever else.
That almost,
bring the dogs up.
Yeah, that almost got him beat up. But the only thing that saved him is I didn't know which dog he was talking about.
Yeah, because if you talking about Harlem... I'm seeing you, B.
I'm not.
Brooklyn is kind of like...
Damn, you're not going to ride for your oldest dog?
I got to ride for Harlem because Harlem ain't going to do nothing.
Harlem's going to lick your face. Harlem is like Mal's dog.
Yeah. Harlem going to lick your face. Brooklyn going to bite the shit out you. Like, he going to hold himself. Harlem just going to look at you like, you ain't got no snacks, my nigga. Like, what's up, man? Like, I don't see nothing in your hand. Like, you know what I mean? Brooklyn going to bite the shit. She going to bite your hand off.
Yeah, regardless.
So it's like,
much.
Let me help Harlem. Let me ride for Harlem.
Yeah, you're right.
Nah, Brooklyn, he's blind now. He don't know what the fuck is going on. He need a ride for both those dogs.
How Bizarre. How Bizarre. How Bizarre.
All right, I don't give a fuck about Bizarre, neither do y'all. So, I mean, I broke it
it's
up because it was out
though.
There.
It's, but it's like, come on, man.
It's been a slow beef week. All of the beefs this week. Did y'all see the Machine Gun Kelly interview?
Yeah, the whites are still
out. I saw clips. I didn't see the whole thing.
Yeah, I seen a clip somebody sent to me on Twitter.
Rory ain't working. Why you ain't see it? The fuck is you doing?
Shit, man.
You're not on the white rapper mail list?
No, I'm not.
You should really be paying attention to this closely.
Rory is involved in the white rapper melee that's going on.
I stayed neutral. I didn't really...
involved with the white rappers.
The white,
I didn't want to pick
white,
sides too quickly.
White Rory Rumble.
Yeah.
White Rory Rumble.
I would like to be the one they call to squash all of this. I'm just letting everyone get their shit off.
You're the J Prince of white rappers.
Yeah, I just want to make
Rumble.
Sure.
Oh, Rory
everyone
Prince.
Get their shit off. I'll bring us all together and solve this.
You do that, man.
Get everyone in a room. All right, so what happened in the MGK interview?
The MGK interview.
I see somebody said that he was trying to avoid a lot of shit, and they made him answer a lot of things. That's what somebody just.
He didn't try to avoid anything at all.
Okay, well that's
he answered saying. Everything very direct, very straightforward. He was to the point. He said he was called in the ring. He stepped up. He did what he had to do. He got out of there. He said he didn't need any help from Puff, his celebrity friends, or anybody else. He said he used to be a big fan of him. Now he's not. I guess all of that shit was cute, but toward the end, I guess I didn't know. They had like an intervention at the end. Mm-hmm. You know, with the passing of Mac Miller.
Oh, yeah.
His drug usage.
Is MGK's
drug usage.
Is he very vocal about his drug usage?
Yes.
Yeah, he has been, okay. I think.
Yeah, he has been. So
well,
he
said he was.
Yeah, they had kind of an intervention up there, and listening to him, he's like, I'm without my mom. I grew up no mom, no dad. You know, just a wild story. So it was a compassionate moment up there.
Oh, that's good. Good for them. Was it a successful intervention, do you think? Well, as successful as they can be?
I don't know.
Yeah, ain't been with them.
I don't know.
What did they, okay. We'd
be able to have a good conversation about this if y'all saw the interview. I urge people to see the interview
What would they be intervening about? His drug use or the rap beef? Like, the rap beef between him and Eminem doesn't need an intervention.
No, that was the end. The drug usage.
Okay.
Not a rap beef.
Yeah, no, I agree with that. Yeah, I mean, I agree with the drug use thing. But listen, man, niggas gonna learn. And slowly but surely, his niggas is gonna learn. Because I still don't understand when that pill shit and all this shit became cool in hip hop. Like, I don't even. To me, that was never a thing. Like, I don't remember in the 90s listening to hip hop and rappers talking about popping pills. I didn't even see dudes popping pills. Like, even my friends, that was never a thing.
Did it?
I don't know if it started with him.
M used to talk about pills a lot too.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I don't know if it started with Wayne.
Wayne, I think, outside of record sales, had a much more cultural impact on music than Eminem did.
Yeah, okay.
Everyone sounds like Wayne.
That's true.
Not very many people sound like Eminem. So they followed a lot of Wayne's blueprint as far as music. I think everyone here kind of sounds like Drake and Wayne combined.
You're right.
Is what the new music is.
Like, I think the most, you know, growing up, I think like the craziest pill dude used to was ecstasy.
Yeah.
Like, to me, that was like, and even when dudes did that, it was more people looking at them like, oh, he bugging out.
Right.
That wasn't like, everybody wasn't trying to partake in that.
People would keep it on the low.
Yeah, it's like, now it's like, I don't know, man. That shit is just weird to me.
Wait, you used to look at your friends that were doing ecstasy as if they were bugging out?
Hell yeah. But I was never into like that type of shit, though.
You're a weirdo, nigga.
Yeah, I was never into that. That was never my thing. Like, I wasn't a big drinker. I wasn't a big smoker.
Get the fuck away from the party, nigga.
No, I'm still in the party.
You're
but
bum ass out. Nah, why are you shit. Around the ecstasy and the
nah,
coke?
Nah, man, fuck that. I don't know. To me, that shit was just never, I don't know.
You ever been dating a girl and found out you did coke? Like, mm-hmm. She went to the bathroom for a few bumps online or something?
I didn't find out like that. Like, she told me that she does that.
Oh, well, tell me more.
We stopped speaking shortly after that.
Wow.
We got, like, dating or just?
I mean, we were dating. Not like, it wasn't nothing serious.
Oh, you coke-shaming?
No, I'm not coke-shaming. It's just that I don't.
You can
it's okay
shame.
if you want to
coke-shame. No, I'm not. You listen.
He was just ecstasy-shaming. So,
no.
You're in the ballpark of shame.
To me, it just was like, that's not my thing. But it was like, if that's your thing, then it's like, cool. But I just know that when people are into shit like that, there's more shit behind that.
Right.
So I just choose to just get away from that.
Next thing you know, you're doing coke with Bizarre in Detroit while you're on tour?
No, I'm not doing that.
Did you beat?
When? Not after the coke bar, no.
Well, before you found out.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, for sure.
You think she was high?
No.
Okay.
Wait.
I never had some coke pussy.
Everybody has had coke pussy before.
Now you want to say, now you want to throw it on us.
Everybody has.
No, slow down.
Trust me, everybody.
Slow down,
yo,
buddy.
More women do coke than you probably, like,
yeah.
Like, yeah. So that's not, it's not.
They be the freaks.
Shit,
yo.
You want to talk about the ones that be the freaks.
I think they're listening to this podcast right now.
For sure.
After
absolutely.
The coke.
Yo, Maul takes his perspective from the Bronx and just applies it to all women.
As he should.
Well, you mean not all women? No.
Well,
I'm saying more women do drugs than you would probably think.
Especially in New York City, I feel like. And L.A. Like,
for sure.
Big coke cities.
For sure. Absolutely. Because a lot of girls that I found out do coke, it surprised me. A lot of girls that I found out, like, Cause when I'm like, oh yeah, you do. They like, yeah, like they're looking at me like I'm the oddball. Like, yeah, nigga, yeah. Duh.
I was shocked when I first moved to New York. You know what I'm saying? People were just like doing lines in the bathrooms regularly.
That's what I'm saying. Like,
damn, y'all just get up like that?
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, I ain't gonna lie. The bathrooms in New York places used to be dope.
It's, I mean, if you like, cocaine, well, they put the
attendant. They put the attendant there now.
Nah,
yeah, it's trash.
He got
now.
It.
No, they got the attendant. Yeah, exactly.
The attendant ain't just the attendant.
Give him fire. Good to go.
Yeah, attendant is the one that got it. You come out the room, he start rubbing his nose. Looking at you like, yeah.
They'd be so mad when you wash your hands and use some of their shit and don't tip them.
Oh, yeah. You can't do that.
I'm not paying for this paper towel.
Yo, yeah. Like, I don't keep that much, like, yeah. White cat. Like, hey, I don't keep, like, a couple ones for the bag.
I went to go get some of the lotion for your hands. That nigga picked up the lotion. I said, fam, like, I can't get some lotion? He looked at me like, nah. Like, that's a paying bathroom people.
The jar towards you a
little. Yeah, that's for people that pay after they piss, man. Not you.
Nigga was mad as hell. I grabbed the big red.
That's a nasty gum to grab too.
Yeah, y'all ever sprayed the
big red is disgusting.
Sprayed the water.
Talk about big red.
Big red is gross.
Big red is disgusting. Red.
Wait, what?
Yeah, three words.
Super dirty.
Yo, y'all are retarded.
You could go chew a sneaker. You might as well go chew like the tongue of a sneaker before you chew a big red.
Yeah. All right, time out. Let me add.
Are you gonna say some
bad season?
Let me add some backstory here. First of all,
I love the backstory.
First of all,
Big Red.
Rory can't even be in this conversation because Rory came up in the age of all the new gums.
That's true.
Like, yeah, you have to excuse yourself.
You came up on Friday.
I'm talking about when it was double mint.
Yeah. Juicy fruit.
Big red.
Juicy fruit.
Yeah. I was still there
the
for all that.
Remember the zebra shit?
The zebra gum. Terrible. You chewed it twice and it was over.
Yeah. That was terrible. That gum was terrible.
Zebra gum.
Yeah.
And
if
was,
you didn't
it was
like,
great for two bites.
If you didn't like none of them three gums, then you had to go to the little
Bazooka Joe's.
Yeah. Also three bites.
A great bazooka.
Asserts.
Oh, the chiclets? Remember the chiclets?
Yeah, oh, I hated chiclets.
Chiclets was terrible.
Yeah.
I hated when a nigga pulled out a big pack of chiclets. Where you going with this big ass stupid pack of chiclets?
Yeah. I had to eat one of them shit. Now I feel like a lion. Get the fuck out of here.
Nah, have y'all ever sprayed the cologne that was in the bathroom? And had water come out.
Certain spots.
You nasty.
I was mad. One nigga had a cologne I had. I said, hold up.
I was about to. I got John Paul Gaultier at home, buddy.
Yeah, like when you see your shit in the bathroom, you like, oh, that's some bullshit cologne I got. You can't have that in the bathroom. Every nigga can smell like what I got at home. Like, nah.
What is your cologne go to?
Probably Chanel.
You look like an oil nigga.
Nah, hell no. Hell nah. A musk.
Musk. 2/5 cop in the
Joe
oil.
Joe is definitely Egyptian musk. Don't touch me. Joe is definitely Egyptian.
You this is, what are you doing?
Nah, because you said I look like an oil nigga. Nah. Joe
right
is definitely
now.
The oil everywhere, nigga. Beard, bald head, arms.
Oil
I see, yeah, Joe did that getting out going to Sin City. I'm like, yo, what's that Egyptian you putting on?
Joe throwing his throwing gold bar on his chest.
Nigga gonna tell me now.
Right
you know, I smoke cigs, so I'll be smelling like cigs. I gotta put the oil on. Get the fuck out of here.
You can't oil your arms, bro.
Arms, that's beard. Sick. Get the fuck out of here. What you mean?
What are you doing right now?
You told me I'm the oil nigga when you the oil nigga.
You look like
the oil nigga.
You look like the oil nigga.
No, I don't. Nigga, you look like the oil nigga. Egyptian musk.
Joe definitely more.
And Joe don't want to tell you where he get his oils from. He's like, nah, I can't put you on my oil, man. You going right to 2/5, nigga.
Wait,
what you mean?
No,
everybody else.
Yeah. No, the funny part is, I did used to say I can't put you on my oil,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, I know. Sure one of them niggas.
I went there one day, though. Oil man wasn't even here no more. Like, I can't even tell niggas where to get the oil.
Yeah, because you bought it off a blanket. He moved it.
Joe
word,
was definitely.
You would have supported
word.
His business.
And I wasn't,
still be there.
And I wasn't the Egyptian musk dude.
But
my shit was lavender or something.
Oh, okay.
The shit I liked.
Okay, my bad.
And it was fire. If I find it today,
you on it?
I'm right back. I'm back like I never left, baby. You can have all your Issei.
Nah, I can't
creams.
Do the oils. Yeah, the oil is over with, man. It's clean.
Oh
over.
No, I think I could do it still.
Nah, I don't think you could. As your friend, you couldn't. Just
why y'all say that?
Stick to the bond, my nigga.
You're fine.
I've been off the bond.
What you want now?
Tom Ford, okay. Joe Malone.
Okay.
I fuck with
them. They ain't paying us. They fuck them niggas.
Or you want us to pump your cologne?
Yeah,
nigga.
I'm back to oils. Egyptian musk
and
all that.
All that.
Word. All right, what are we talking about? I be having good jokes, and then y'all flip it on me, and I forget. I was about to tear something up. Now I don't remember nothing. Now I'm like, what do we got?
You gotta write your jokes down, nigga. What you mean?
No, I'm not writing my jokes now. Yo, let's talk about, let's give some props to Joel Santana.
What Joel's doing?
So no, he's chilling. He's chilling.
Don't try to give props to your in-law.
All right, let me see where you're going with this in-law. I'm
trying to connect the dots.
Oh, my God. Rory, I never thought you could be this corny. Rory. All right, hold up. Let's take it. Are you okay?
I'm fine, man. I'm fine.
Wow. I'm fine. I just caught it. God damn, I'm slow. That was terrible.
Oh, my God. He get a few of these.
In-laws?
In-law.
Forget it, man.
God,
yeah, we're supposed to move on.
Sin Santana, Jewels, Santana.
Rory, get out.
Rory.
Get the fuck out.
Time out, bro.
Get the fuck out. Get out, man.
How are you guys doing?
How's everyone doing?
No, we're fine.
So, Jewels, what's Jewels doing?
He started a new trend, man.
Again?
Plies got caught.
Oh, man. Yeah, I saw that.
He got caught.
That's not a good trend.
I saw that. Yeah, don't follow that trend, please.
T-Pain got caught.
He did?
Yeah, but
he was registered, though.
He walked right out. T-Pain's white,
and it was
man.
In Atlanta.
T-Pain's white. Like, he would be the guy with the clean, registered gun.
Serial number still on
two serials
there.
On it.
Smart man, T-Pain.
Yeah, man. Fuck out of here. Being smart and hip-hop.
Being responsible.
Yeah. But Plies looked like he was under some pressure.
Somebody said that he asked the police not to take his hat off in the airport.
I wouldn't be mad. I've said that a bunch of times.
Don't take your hat off.
I'm listen. When the cuffs go on me, is when I give my request.
The police don't take your hat. But please, the police don't take your hat off when they put cuffs on you.
Oh, now
they check your hat.
There's a lot that they
do. No, they'll check it, but they'll put it back on. Like, what's wrong with that?
Have you ever asked a police officer to light a cigarette for you while you were cuffed?
I have.
Listen, man, we ain't gonna get into what Joe be doing.
I'm kind of curious what some of his requests are.
No, we not gonna go there.
Yo, Mall is.
Can y'all stop at Dunkin' Donuts? Need to get a coffee
with a straw.
I'm gonna be here for
this
a while.
Nigga Joe is different. Locked up Joe is different.
Oh, you've told the story.
I'm not telling. I'm just saying locked up Joe is very different.
Mall is so mad that I had the fucking cell lit with a cigarette.
I'm not mad.
You was mad in the cell.
I'm not mad.
Like you was part of the other group that was like, come on, we ain't never gonna get out of here.
Nah, nigga, I see.
Nah, yeah. Yes, you was.
Get the fuck out of here. I ain't say that, nigga. I never said that. Get the fuck out of here, nigga.
Wait. No, the
cell was huddled around the toilet. Cell.
Them niggas was huddled around the toilet blowing smoke in the bowl.
Did you light the cigarette with the microwave?
No, I lit it with the matches in my bowl.
This nigga just say microwave? Yeah, no microwave inside the cell, nigga. Where the fuck you thought we was at?
I don't know.
In the fucking bookings, nigga.
Yeah, you're in the drunk tank.
Yeah, it was 500 niggas in there.
Oh, yeah,
a nice spacious.
Only one of us had the cigs,
and one nigga had a match. Book a match,
and so somebody had a match.
Oh, you were the only one.
So
with
now
cigs?
The cell was split up, and I'm looking, and I'm.
That's dangerous to be the only one with cigs.
So the cell is split up.
That pack is gone.
You can smell some of the smoke in the hallway. So now the CO's walking by. Yo, I smell it. Letting y'all know, y'all ain't gonna see the judge for another 70 months. So now,
life bid in the tombs.
Yo, the smokers don't give a fuck. It's fuck, suck my dick, nigga.
Hey,
we are smoking to the filter. This shit is brown. Say, hey, somebody in the cell say, yo, I'm going to put that shit out, man. We ain't never getting out of here. I look over Maul standing over there with him. I'm like, well, I know you don't smoke,
Maul, but
come on. No, I was
Maul,
standing
over. First of all, we in a cell. There's only so many places
you
can
stand. Yeah, but
stand
by me.
But you, nigga, it's 10 niggas on one cigarette by the toilet bowl.
You my man. You stand by me.
Standing. Get the fuck out
Why
of
not?
Here.
Why not?
That's a crazy
nigga, y'all
cipher.
Niggas was blowing smoke in the toilet and flushing at the same. That was just a weird. I'm looking like, yo,
what's
niggas get creative. Niggas get creative on the inside.
That's what I do in the airport.
That's what I was trying to look at them and say, like, yo, that's not stopping
at least
the smell.
Wad up the t-shirt and blow it into the shirt.
Them niggas was blowing in the bowl and flushing at the same time.
You can't flush smoke.
Yeah. Parks, I'm glad somebody. Now you understand
and you
why
know
I was
they
sitting
felt
on,
like geniuses when it
fam,
was happening.
Well, now you understand why I'm sitting on the other side really of the cell idea. Looking like I'm like you niggas. I see why some of you niggas is locked up. You niggas is stupid.
That's a disgusting
you niggas is stupid, man.
I be flushing smoke though.
Taking blunt hits of cigarettes.
I know y'all don't believe it, but it be happening.
No, it doesn't.
Oh my god,
y'all are idiots.
We are idiots. You the ones blowing smoke in the toilet going
gravity doesn't even work there.
Fam, now you understand it why I was sitting over there looking at these niggas like,
and hold on, it's the bookings toilet too. Oh, they don't even flush like that
toilet anyway.
I'm like, I was leaning on that shit.
I'm like, dog,
bare forearm.
I'm
all
like, we ain't
on
never
it
getting out of
the
here.
The oil didn't make it slip off.
Yeah, I was chilling.
Yeah, you was chilling.
I was having a blast. I was like, hey, by law, what? How long can they keep?
Because I have six
get
cigarettes left.
Get the fuck
left
out of here.
What?
Is it a day oh, because all six? Joe was trying to do was ration the cigs. Like, okay, how many hours yeah, I got left on the cigs?
Hey, they can't keep us in here forever. Yeah, they have to fact allow us to see a judge at some point.
They tried to keep us in here forever, though.
Yo, I was watching something last night. I was watching this documentary on 9/11.
You're flushing the smoke, man.
You're insensitive.
Sorry, carry on.
I'm talking about 9/11 here.
All right, carry on.
Yeah.
Don't try to escape with 9/11.
Yeah,
well, actually, I'm about to say some insensitive shit.
Great. From you?
But I'm about to try and like make it sweet.
Gotcha.
And not insensitive, because I would never be insensitive to, you know, such a tragic historical event. But I was watching the doc.
With that said.
White people, it's crazy. But not white people. I don't blame white people. I blame, it's corporate. It's like a corporate, I can just spot a corporate mind state. But anyway, I'm watching this doc, 911, right? Mm-hmm. And I was talking about, it was a very detailed doc. I think it was on the History Channel, I want to say. And they was talking about how when the first plane hit, they got into the people that survived. And the floors that they hit, they focused on who worked at those floors. Like Bank of America was there, and like they got into it. So they covered the first plane hitting the first building, right? And they covered in depth the actions of everybody in the second building. And mm-hmm. I guess long story less long. After the first plane hit the first building, a lot of people in the other building didn't know what was going on, but when they were walking down the steps, like when they got word and they were trying to leave, or when they saw balls of fire, because gravity don't work that way, balls of fire going down, mm-hmm. they said that they were single file, like two at a time, going down 87 flights of stairs in the second building.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And that's where I'm confused.
My mother's best friend worked in the second tower, and they were saying, no, stay at your desks when it first happened.
Yeah, they holy said they said the announcement
and her
went
husband
out
came and got her and said, get the fuck out of that building.
The announcement went out to say, hey, y'all can stay or y'all can leave. Everything is cool.
Everything was not cool.
Mm-mm.
What would, I just don't understand.
That noise must have been so loud that you would go, that can't be cool.
Yeah.
Just the
those
walking
buildings ain't
down
that far away.
Dude, walking down them stairs must have been fucking terrifying.
I'm watching that shit saying, fam, I would have been zooming, even not knowing what was going on in the other building, not knowing anything, I would have been zooming out of that building. This single foul bullshit that they want. I'm telling you, man, the decision that you make in a split second is just can save a life or determine
well,
one.
In their defense, if it was haywire, people would probably got trampled down the steps and all types of shit. So single file is relatively smart and to some degree.
Yeah, more people got out that way.
Yeah. If everybody would have been running
if everybody
down,
in that building was trying to just run
stairs
to the staircase, and, yeah, it wouldn't have been. Wouldn't be good.
Okay, I understand that. Mm. I'm telling y'all what Joe was doing. Joe was running, and you wasn't stopping me from running.
Yeah, you had to get out of there.
But it was a really good doc. Really good doc. Sin fell asleep. She tight. So check out that doc if you're bored in bed like I was on the History Channel on 9/11. That's all I got.
Okay. Thanks.
For all you doc people out there. We ain't really been talking about the shows because I haven't seen Ozark.
Oh, you have it?
It's I'm trying.
I'm purposely not.
Halfway through it.
I'm purposely staying away from it. I want to watch it when everybody's finished. I want to watch it maybe in the spring. Like, okay. Like Ozark is one of those for me. I have to get into it.
Yeah.
And I'm too busy.
It was a good season.
Yeah, I'm almost finished with Peaky Blinders finally. This shit is crazy.
Yeah, it's a dope show too.
Oh, that shit is crazy.
Oh, because you did start that. I've never seen it still.
Oh, my God. It's dope. Yo, you trust me.
Everybody keeps saying that.
Trust me. You want, yes.
Yeah, some gangster British people doing gangster British people things.
Yes. It's one of those.
It's British.
One of those.
Yeah.
But it's British.
Yeah, but it's, you going, it's still in English. They speak English.
Put the subtitles on, though, because their accents their are language. So heavy.
That is true.
Their accents are so heavy at times you might not understand.
I never got into Game of Thrones either.
Oh, yeah?
That's not really my style. That's why I never got into it.
Dragons and shit was never my thing.
The last couple seasons were super hard.
Dexter lost me.
Yeah.
That Peaky Blinders, man.
I'm going to check it out.
Yeah, you should.
Just because you said that. Because I remember you saying you were going to check it out. Yeah. You're saying it's good now. Snowfall, I haven't seen it all yet.
Oh, my God.
Well, this season, I haven't seen it at all yet.
Oh, it's two seasons?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
This is the second season. The season finale, I think.
Second season is over.
Yeah.
So, end it.
That was quick.
Yeah, it was. It went by quick. It did. But it was dope.
I ain't seen the last few episodes of The Center. I'm staying away from TV right now, purposely.
I haven't seen any of season two of The Center.
Because I'm waiting for my couch.
I feel you.
When my couch comes, I'm watching everything.
Yeah. You get the new couch, the new TV.
Yeah, I'm breaking up. I'm 100% breaking up with Sin.
Just to watch TV.
To watch TV in your living room.
Listen, I'll be in the living room. What do you want to do? Come here.
Come down here.
Come hang out. I wanted to talk about something important. Oh, the modern, the Music Modernization Act.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's what I want to talk about. I just don't know anything about it.
Yeah, I tried to read about it, and it's complicated as fuck.
It's a massive overhaul of the copyright law, essentially. So the intent is to upgrade for the digitalization, streaming, all that kind of shit. There's a bunch of shit in there that's... it remains to be seen if it's good. It seems like it's good. It sounds good. The part that's worrisome, I guess, is that everybody seems to like it. Like, why does Apple like this?
Yeah, I'm going to have to call my lawyer.
Yeah.
Yeah, for real.
I need a little bit more of an intense breakdown of it. Every article pretty much just says how much everyone loves it, and that's a little sketchy. But there's some good things about it. It seems to be that there's going to be better royalty payment options, payouts.
The articles make it seem as though this is great for all parties.
Yeah, which is
artists,
not possible,
labels.
Nothing is ever good for all parties.
I was
going to
say, how is that even possible?
Right. Yeah, nothing is ever good for all parties.
Well, Spotify just announced... And I would big them up even if we weren't on Spotify. Let me just say that. And by the way, don't forget to use promo code Joe, J-O-E, for 2 free premium months of Spotify. Now, Spotify will allow independent artists to upload directly.
That's awesome. Mm.
Yeah, I was reading that too.
Yeah, which I think even more for the labels, like the TuneCores of the world, that's terrifying for them.
For sure.
Which always makes me happy. Mm. Well, when they're uncomfortable.
Yeah.
From the way things are supposed to go.
I don't know if they're the enemy, but...
Yeah, I don't know that TuneCore's the enemy either. Yeah.
No, I mean, they do allow indie artists to do it, but it is nice that they can go directly and just upload that shit to streaming services.
It's not very expensive. I put out albums on TuneCore and CD Baby, and it's not very expensive. So
okay.
It costs like $50 to put an album up.
Do they get a percentage? Say you sell really well.
I think CD Baby takes a percentage, but they don't charge up front. TuneCore charges you a yearly fee, and then they don't take shit.
Okay.
So.
All right, well, that's not too bad.
Yeah.
But still, shout out to artists to be able to just put that shit out.
Yeah, it's cool.
Because anytime I see an artist send me, like, some weird-ass link, even I'm like, nah, I don't want to click that shit.
Yo, y'all should hang out more often.
Yeah, they getting into all that. Yeah.
Y'all should hang out. You ever met Rory?
That's Rory. Rory, that's Parks.
Oh, hey, what's up, man?
Y'all just had a moment. A little nerd.
Are you guys
moment.
Not interested in that?
No, I like seeing the nerds like have their moments.
A little nerd out, right? Yeah. Now, there's some other interesting shit in the MMA thing, though. There's like more defined royalty payouts for engineers and producers, which I think is good, but also bad because now producers and engineers, particularly engineers who are typically the lowest paid people on the totem pole for the most part, have to lawyer up and probably manager up because if you're getting offered royalties instead of upfront money, people are going to use that shit. People try to use that shit anyway.
if you're doing
well, that's what A&Rs used to do.
Yeah, but it used to, but it used to not exist really.
Yeah,
right.
So if it's a real thing now, how do you feel about that?
I mean, it's weird because, like I said, you have to lawyer up now. So in the royalty that they've established, quote unquote, is 2%. So like, it's really probably not that much money unless it's a huge record.
Mm-hmm.
And then the other thing is weird too is like, what if you just get a feature from somebody? So now you got to bust down your 2% with a couple other engineers that you never met and might have just been, you know what I mean? Like, yeah. And that's your ticket.
So you think just a regular fee is better in the long run?
I mean, I think it should be a little bit of both, honestly.
Okay.
And for those that can negotiate that, then they can get that. But not everybody can do that. So I think it's going to be a barrier of entry for up and coming engineers, honestly. Because now you have, like I said, you have to get a lawyer. Unless you're just going to sign some shit blindly.
I got to bust down some more money there.
Exactly. Exactly. Lawyers ain't cheap.
For me, I think I'm paying attention to what this means in the larger fight that I've been paying close attention to between the labels and the techies. And they've been fighting for years over the new rules, over the new game.
Right.
And it seemed like the labels were winning because they, you know, I don't know what I'm trying to say. The labels seemed to be winning that, and it seemed that the companies needed to find a way around them the same way that YouTube did. Right?
But I still kind of feel like, in a sense, that it's the labels and the techies versus the artists, because at one point all the labels had shares in the streaming platforms. They was all invested in Spotify,
right.
But that was the fight. That was the fight.
If I'm an artist and my label and the people that are putting out my music are in cahoots, if you will, right. I'm even more uncomfortable.
There's also one other interesting clause that I read when I read the actual bill, which is pretty rough to read, but there's a clause in here that prevents anybody essentially from suing people that make recording devices and media. So,
what does
to
that
me,
mean?
That sounds like you're letting Apple off the hook for anything.
Yeah, you can't sue Apple.
You can't sue Apple for shit.
Yeah.
That's interesting.
That's a very interesting little segment.
Well, I guess that's why they were so happy.
Exactly.
They're not held accountable. Right. Can't sue us.
Yeah, listen, have a blast. Man. They'll sign that right now.
Right.
Here's your $10. Have a blast.
Right.
Yeah, I got to find out what a lot of this stuff means for all parties involved, because I'm still a little unclear.
There's also one other thing that there's a segment of this that says that if you put like ID3 information in the MP3 tag where it says name and all that shit, they have to duplicate that on whatever service. So mm-hmm. that kind of tells me that they will be forced to put more credits on shit if people put the credits in the tag of the file.
Mm-hmm.
So that's kind of interesting.
And if you're forced to put the credit there, one would assume that they're paying out.
Yeah, actually, yeah, that's another byproduct of that. So yeah. there's a lot of shit in there. Like I said, it's a huge overhaul of copyright law.
I'm always against labels, so I'm on the side that's against labels, and that's where I fall. I think Spotify focusing on podcasts has something to do with all of this shit. I think that Spotify allowing artists to upload direct has something to do with all of this shit. Spotify just struck me as a company that was gearing up for everything that was about to happen moving forward.
Yeah, I'm sure they were hip to some of these clauses and shit in here and adjusted their revenue streams accordingly.
And I'm sure I'd have got a phone call if any of that meant bad things.
or not. Would you have?
No, I'd have got a call. I would have got a call. Maybe I would have got a call.
Yeah, I don't know about all
that. Maybe I'm feeling myself.
History shows.
Fuck off, maybe. Guys.
You guys see that Suge got sentenced?
Yeah, 28 years or something like that?
Yeah, man.
The old blind line didn't work, huh?
The old passing out in court didn't work.
Listen, I'm still not making jokes on Suge, man.
You got 28 years, man. Don't worry about it. You got
38 and 28. Carried us. Six.
Suge is only 38.
Carried a six. What?
I'm joking, Maul. Yeah, Maul don't miss a beat when it comes down to Clown Joe. Carried a six. What did you say?
No, because you said 38. I'm mad quiet. Suge ain't no 38.
No, I'm 38. Oh, I was adding 28 and 38. So 8 and 8, 16. I'm just 2 and carry the 4 over.
Got you. Don't I got worry. It.
Now, as long as you carry the 4 and the 2 over, you good.
All right, so what do y'all always say shit and then just never say what y'all think.
Well, I was asking
you. Yo, y'all say you heard about that Shook shit?
But yeah. I know, but
all right, now what?
I read that was part of the plea, though. So I'm like, damn, if that was the plea, like...
Well, he killed somebody.
They was trying to get him on a straight-up murder, like...
Oh, okay.
Premeditated, he went there to kill that person.
Didn't he run over someone in his car that he didn't like?
Yeah, a few times. Yeah.
I mean,
he hit somebody.
Yo, but put it in gear, put it in reverse.
28 is pretty solid.
But
that's quite a plea.
So what, he was facing life?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Right. Well, that's a sad way to go out. I mean, that story ended for him terribly.
Yeah.
Yeah, so...
What was the happy ending supposed to be for Suge Knight?
I mean, Suge doing 28 years in jail for killing somebody with his vehicle? That's like, compared to where he was, how we were introduced to Suge? Like, that story just ended terrible.
Sounds about right.
Compared to the guy that got ran over by the car.
What is Mal talking
about right now?
No, it's a sad ending to what was maybe the inevitable.
Yeah.
He's alive. He ain't dead. What are you talking about, Mal?
This
is a sad ending.
His age getting
28 years? Knight's life.
Yeah, like that's a sad... How old is Suge, Savon?
Savon on the phone.
53. You got what? 30 or 20?
Carry the 8.
Yeah, 28 years, yeah. When you 50 and you get 28 years.
That's 81. What?
That's life. It's over.
Nigga, you know how strong my granddaddy was at 81?
It's over.
And he was fucking a little young 28? Thing at 81.
Oh, so, now my granddad's the only one that was fucking a little young thing, huh? is that what we're doing in the room?
My grandpa's still alive.
He was out there by
still
himself.
Kicking.
It's cool. I'll start talking to Rory about his dad. Fuck his granddad. What are we talking about? This Saturday shit has no structure.
none at all. Did you guys like the Drake and French record?
That's the one that Berg did?
Berg didn't do it.
He didn't do that one? Which record?
Nah, it was London. London on the Track did it.
Which record did Berg do with Drake and French?
That's
an exclusive you got. You just switched on Berg.
That's some shit on your phone.
Nah, for real.
I didn't get that email.
He was just doing the video for it, I think.
Mo, what are you talking about?
No.
I don't know what you're talking about, bro.
I mean, you might be right. I don't know.
Okay. That's why I'm saying I don't know what you're talking about. I'm not trying to play him. What was up?
I thought it was up.
Mo do be having it. He used to have exclusives.
That was a
phone.
Scoop. He just dropped the scoop.
Now.
No, I'm serious.
You don't want the scoop?
You got a scoop.
The scoop.
I don't want the scoop. No, I don't want the scoop, bro. Fuck out of here. You don't want the scoop.
Yeah, everything is not offensive, man.
I know, but I'm just saying, I don't want the scoop. No, I'm not looking down there. It's not my scoop.
Yours to have.
No, thank you, bro.
Looking down at the
thank
scoop.
Thank you for offering me the scoop.
What are we supposed to talk about, like, lines that niggas drop to make their ex come home?
Wait, that on the docket?
No, but we talking about it now. I want to hear some of y'all lines.
Oh, mine's is easy.
What's yours?
I'm dying.
You can't go straight to the I'm dying line, bro. That's like when it's bad. Like it's all the way. You have nothing left. Nothing else.
What do you want me to do, Mal?
Yeah, the fake suicide attempt is definitely.
If throwing your clothes and on the street out the window don't work, then I'm dying. You better get over here. All your shit is outside. What you mean? What?
You throw them two sweatsuits in the garbage.
Your shit line still is batting 1,000.
Is it?
No.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not. Nah. No, it is not, Rory. Rory is incorrect.
Yeah.
The women have huddled together and they've learned to counter that shit. That don't work at all.
If a girl told you that, would you go get your shit?
No, but I'm talking about women.
Nah, they're not getting it either now. They're leaving it.
Yeah, Fashion Nova's cheap, man.
My nigga, my ex hit me with that and I was ready to. Parts. You could throw that shit out. That shit
Work. Anything I got at your crib, I need you, probably
you
even that
value. Throw them tech suits out, them Nikes.
You didn't want the 8s?
Nah, I'm cool. I didn't want the 8s, bro. Throw them shits in the garbage.
Wait, so it goes from picking your shit to suicide? There's no middle ground there?
And let me keep it up. I'm going to keep it all the way 100 with you. When the chick tell you, yo, I don't want it. Just leave it. Do whatever you want with it. Oh, man.
Would you do burn it and send a picture?
No, I'm delivering that shit to her crib.
Oh, talk about the sunken
now
place.
We at your crib.
I don't want it. Do whatever you want with it.
Fam, it's over. So that's the sign it's truly over. Once you tell you, yo, do whatever you want with it, my nigga, I'm cool.
Nah,
like, fam, it's a fur.
If she say that.
Find a chick that wear her size and put her on Insta story.
Nah. You flirting with death.
She said, do whatever you want with it.
If you hang up after she says that, like, all right, cool. Just hang up. And she don't call back, like, text it, then
it's over. It's over, yeah.
Mom.
You got to chuck that one up.
The chick that tells you that she don't care, just keep all the shit. She ain't texting back. My G, it's over.
That's what I'm saying. True. If she don't,
it's over.
If you hang up on her, all right, cool. I'll throw it out.
Yeah, she's got whole dick in her mouth now. For real.
Fresh off the breakup?
100. But are you kidding
me?
Fresh
off the breakup.
You cool with your girl sucking dick straight off the breakup?
Absolutely not.
Oh, okay. I was about to say, that's crazy.
Hell no.
Yeah, I'm not cool.
That's crazy. If you just break up with your girl and she's sucking dick.
even if I broke up with you, I'm still not cool with it.
While the clothes are still in the crib? Like, come on, man. Yeah. That's crazy. Her clothes are still in the house and she's sucking dick?
I can't believe Maul is the person that thinks that that doesn't happen.
It absolutely.
No, if you just fucking with a chick, yeah. But I'm talking about a girlfriend, like shit is at your crib. Like, that means y'all was really fucking with each other. If y'all just broke up and she's already sucking dick. That's crazy.
It was never your girlfriend.
That's exactly.
That's like, not true. What
nah,
y'all saying.
Nah, that was never you.
The woman
you
checks
always
out of the
her.
Relationship first sometimes.
Yeah, but if we officially break up.
Oh, now you're using words like officially. Shut up, nigga.
No, because I'm saying if we
go. What type of goof ass nigga
if
are
we
you?
We going through shit.
Officially.
No, if you're going through shit, like you just say, they mentally they leave the relationship a long time, cool. But now if we officially broke it off and some of your shit is still in my house, and you and I'm we speaking, and you like yo, she says you could do whatever you want. If she's currently sucking dick at that point, my nigga, that's still crazy.
Mom's crazy. All
right, I guess I'll stand alone in that.
Just tell me what officially broke up is.
Like where y'all both had to talk. Like y'all both know. Listen, we going our separate ways.
That don't
like,
mean shit.
She can't be sucking dick fresh off that conversation.
Oh no, she definitely can't
talk.
Yeah, like so you know what? So you clear? Like, all right, well, you not my girl. We not together. Get your shit out. Whatever. That's the talk. But you could be in your house walking around not speaking for a week. Like, that don't mean that you right, single, well,
can,
nigga.
Can you
girls
get some pussy
always
right away?
First, girls mm-hmm. always.
Can you get some pussy right away?
It depends.
Wow.
It depends.
No, I'm on your side with a double standard. Either way, though.
Yeah, it depends.
I can definitely
like
go
if
get
she
some pussy.
If she did something like
and you can't.
She did some fucked up shit. Then it's kind of like, that's just like the revenge fuck. Like, all right, fuck you. I'm out here. I'm slinging dick now. But if it's some shit where y'all just, you know.
How do you pick the revenge fuck?
What is a revenge fuck, Maul?
When you just fuck a chick that you know you don't really
that
like.
That sounds like some shit Lisa Bloom said at some point.
You just don't really like her. And you're just like, whatever. I'm just mad right now. Let me just go get some pussy.
What is the revenge fuck? Have to be someone close to her? Like a friend or a relative?
No. Don't do that. Because
that's really revenge.
That's grimy. No, that's super grimy. No, you playing with life and death now. You can't go fuck her homegirl.
You can't go fuck the fortune to her cookie?
No. No. Not at all. Or the vet to her rookie.
I never did. I never was that nigga. That's nasty.
No, you can't do that.
I don't play them. That'll get you stabbed again.
Yeah. Again.
So you was that guy?
Who, me?
Yeah.
Hell no. Are you kidding me? Do y'all care about fucking this Mark Cuban shit? He gets a nasty award. I don't care what y'all say.
You might be right.
He gets a nasty award. He's nasty.
Yeah, you're supposed to fire homie.
Yeah.
100%.
I agree.
100%.
You got to go, bro.
He knew about
give,
it,
give
was having drinks with him.
He leaving, a backstory here.
He leaving cummy condoms on the fucking...
Yeah,
office
come
floor,
on.
You nasty. You gotta go, bro.
Yeah,
you might have to get arrested.
You ain't that busy at Shark Tank.
Yeah, exactly. It does sound disgusting.
You ain't that busy at Shark Tank.
Yeah.
We're watching.
You don't even speak on that show.
Yeah.
It'd be the whole panel. Mark Cuban just be sitting over there smiling,
shaking his head, stealing well, ideas.
Can't wait to get back to the Mavs office. Giving it up over there.
The Mavs office. This is nasty office. The Mavs office. Come to the Mavs office.
There's only one Maverick.
Come
in
to
here.
The Mavs office and watch your step. There's condoms everywhere. There's gooey condoms everywhere.
Gooey. All right.
Watch your step on the way out. When you rich though, look, that's the crazy shit that goes on though when you rich, man.
Yeah.
You just in your office, just nasty shit happening. Be broke and try that.
Right by the trophy.
Check out the bottom of your
boot. Be broke and try to leave a gooey condom on the floor. Somebody gonna look at that shit immediately. Who nasty ass did this? When you rich, niggas step right over the nasty condom.
That's pretty standard here.
Yeah, like another day at the office.
That's why you shouldn't wear condoms.
See, it's always one.
Get rid of the evidence.
It's always one in the crew.
One in the crew.
It's always one in the crew. You go always tell which one of your homies don't bag up.
Wait, don't what?
Don't bag up.
Shut the fuck up.
You go always
up,
tell. Bro. Start talking about cons. One nigga be like, I don't. It'd be a lot of grunt.
That's how y'all get down.
Yeah, like, that's what y'all be doing.
You need the condoms. You and your revenge fucking ass.
I don't
ass.
Need the condoms. I'm not.
The nigga been single
sex.
For 20 years. Having
nah,
revenge sex.
No, nah, the revenge fuck has to have a pregnancy.
Who are you
scare.
Revenging?
Wait. Watch your mouth. Man. Don't talk to me like that. Brother. Watch your mouth, all right? I've had relationships.
No. Who are you revenging?
I've had relationships, man.
Like enough to like want revenge on them?
Maul was definitely wearing the OVO revenge chain.
Wait, what? Hey, Rory. Hey, Rory. You my
I'm
man.
I'm chilling.
All right, okay. But act like you chilling, though. Because I hear you saying you chilling, but I don't know if your actions is matching
words.
I'm over
here chilling, bro.
Rory be doing that. He be saying he chilling, but
yeah,
he don't really
his actions
chilling.
Is everything unchill.
What song you be playing when you want to get in your revenge?
Go ahead, man. Play the record. He gonna hold it. Look. This nigga gonna hold this shit and look at me. Get the fuck out of here, nigga. That's a sick ass revenge.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm gonna get that bitch now.
Crib. Hell yeah.
Pete's on.
A nigga listening to this walking in the club looking for ass is crazy. You get out the whip playing that and walk in the club. Listen, two drinks and we out of here. You heard?
I feel great when I'm upset comes on. I love that song.
That's the craziest part about it.
I used to hate happy that. Little bop to
I hated that song when the album came out.
Yeah,
I'm upset.
When it
I'm
first
happy
the
when
single
it comes
came
on.
Out, it was like,
oh, I trashed
this?
The shit out of that single. Yeah. Now I'd be singing that shit at the top of my lungs. We was wrong about that one.
What key
wrong.
Is the top of your lungs?
I'll have to get the app.
I can't ask.
What G-flat. Key?
I can't ask a question.
What key is the top
yeah,
of your lungs?
Yeah, because I never heard that
never
tone.
Heard. Rory's. He's, right. He keep talking. We can get there.
What key exactly is the top of your tone?
Y'all never was following a chick in a car. And you got
wait,
caught
whoa,
at
whoa,
the
hold
light,
on. He was doing what? He was doing what, bro?
Yo, you were talking about Instagram.
No.
Following a chick
in real
car.
Life, you talking life about. Following. Yeah.
I'm asking my friends questions.
You ever get
Saturday.
Caught at the light?
For real. Y'all, that never happened to nobody?
No.
Nope.
Y'all never was following a chick.
No.
We answered you. How many times
you
want
to ask
nigga,
it a different
we
way.
Answered you. No, we never it. Followed a chick and got
wait,
caught at the light.
But y'all don't have cars.
It don't matter.
What I did, we never did.
Yeah, we still never right. Followed a chick.
All right, when y'all get a car, I'm going to ask y'all.
No, it's going to be no again. I promise you.
Nigga, you wanted revenge sex. Yeah. You're not far off for following
no, nigga,
somebody.
I'm not following no chick in my car. And they get caught at the light. And you start thinking, yo, this shit got cameras. I'm about to eat this.
This shit worth a ticket.
Yeah.
My bum ass ran one and then got caught at the very next one. Like, all right, let me go. I'm going home.
Wait, so once she arrives at her destination,
fuck this, I'm going home.
What happens when she gets to her destination?
That bitch made two left and was gone.
I didn't know she could drive so well.
Yeah, word, because she didn't even know I was there.
Yeah, you doubt a chick driving knew. Skills? But no, she can drive,
I'm honking at somebody like, move, man, I'm following this chick.
Like, well, she could drive. this bitch know how to drive. I was two cars behind her. This bitch on the freeway already. This bitch know how to drive.
Oh, she could drive.
I'm stuck behind the Dodson.
I knew she could drive. Every time I'm in the car with her, I'm upset with her. This bitch getting the car by herself.
What can she park?
Oh my god!
The probably
yo,
she definitely can't park.
She
bro.
Cannot park.
I'm upset. What were you listening to when you was following her?
My thoughts.
Okay, that's dangerous.
Yeah, no radio on.
Newport.
Just me. And
silence in the car is
listening to Newport
terrifying.
Smoke.
Listening to Newport Smoke, thinking about flushing it down the toilet.
Hotboxing the whip with Newports, no window open.
You guys are awesome.
You guys are great.
Are y'all going to get a car?
Yeah.
I've been thinking about it, but still no. There's nowhere to park over here, man.
Yeah, man.
You got a driveway.
That's true, but...
I think it's crazy. Yo, New Yorkers is so cheap.
I got nowhere to park. You got a driveway. And your name is Parks. No. Fuck you mean you ain't your got nowhere to park? Parks. How your name is Parks and you ain't got nowhere to park?
No parking everywhere.
Yeah, so Parks is crazy.
Parks ain't got nowhere
Parks
to park.
Parks can't go nowhere in the city.
Oh, my God.
Now you got to change your name.
You got to change your name.
You can't be Parks if you can't park.
Yeah, like you got to change your name.
New Yorkers just refuse to pay the fucking $40 a month to park in the driveway or something.
It ain't $40.
So what is it?
That deal at?
What is it?
That should be a couple hundred.
Definitely a couple hundred.
Nigga, I'm paying the two to park in the city whenever you want. Y'all know the shit we spend $200 on?
You right, though.
Parking here is crazy in New York, though. Yeah. I remember my homeboy was...
No, New York, everything is crazy.
I used to have a car, but I got rid of it because I got tired of parking that bitch.
No, listen.
Just collecting parking.
I remember we was in Canada, and my cousin was circling the block. We going to the club. So I'm like, why you keep circling the block? I'm trying to find parking. Mind you, we passed two parking lots. You know, from New York, we see a parking lot. Ain't no parking. Going to the lot, yeah. I'm like, man, just going to the lot. He said, nah, man, I ain't paying for that. I said, well, how much is it? I'm thinking New York price is 40. You know that shit, $40.
Don't say he said 12.
$5, my nigga. I said, if you don't park this fucking car, stop playing with me, man.
I'll take two. I'll take two spots. Here's a ten.
Yeah, $5, and you don't want
to. 15. Park I want this, a car next to mine.
Yeah, park this park fucking car, man.
And one from behind.
$5. Nah, I'm parking on the street.
New York be like,
matter of fact, give me this whole lot.
New York be like, yo, if you're gonna be longer than an hour, let me tell you now, it's $79. And if you got four doors, it's $300.
Yeah, like that shit is crazy.
And let me know when you're leaving because you have to.
And
wait
don't let them have to put your shit on the lift. And then you come back to my nod. Ain't let me in the club, fam. 60.
You the ninth car up.
60. Like, bro, but I ain't get it. $60, fam. You want your car or not?
New York is crazy. Yo, they trying to kick, they fucking white people, they trying to kick all the black people out of Manhattan.
Yeah, they are.
We didn't talk about that in this podcast, but they are.
Are you talking about gentrification?
They're doing Dykeman now.
Oh, I don't consider Harlem Manhattan. I guess.
I know.
Watch your mouth, folks.
No, you.
But
is that
is,
wrong?
But it is Manhattan.
Wrong. It's Manhattan.
But I consider it Uptown, which I guess is
Uptown Manhattan.
And let's start with Harlem. They got black people out of Harlem.
Yeah, that's
so
true.
Well, the East Side is still kind of
moved in there and said.
So Harlem is done. Downtown is done. Once they do Dykeman.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Yeah, the next 5-10 years.
You can't clear out Dykeman.
They're clearing out Dykeman. They just got Safari out of there.
Wait, that was the tell for you. That's how you knew it was over.
Just got Safari out of there.
No, I think it's fucked up what they're doing though. Honestly,
yeah, it's been fucked up.
They raising shit to astronomical.
They're doing it in every single borough, man.
Yeah, for sure.
Every single one.
I don't know why New Yorkers won't move to Jersey. I don't get it.
And they kick people out and then the buildings stay empty. Is the craziest part.
I'm moving back to Jersey.
Are you?
Yeah.
You can't just drop that line. Tell us more.
I was telling you.
I was thinking about it, but I think I'm going to move back. I'm just so familiar with it. I was there for so many years. Like, it's just like, and it's more quiet. You get more for your dollar there.
Yeah,
it's not as hot over there.
Yeah, it's quiet.
Taxes are lower,
yeah.
I think.
Yeah. I mean, I ain't trying to have... Niggas can't just pop up in Jersey. Y'all, I'm on your block. No, you're not.
Yeah, come on.
No, you're not.
Where you're at in Jersey.
No, you're not. You're not just on the block.
Yeah, to throw it out the window. Yeah, just custody's popping up.
Relax. Calm down. I heard you the first time, but I heard you say it. You can't just throw it out the window. I got what you were saying. Relax, man.
I didn't know.
I know, but calm down. Sure. I got you.
What part of Jersey?
I don't know yet.
You gonna live alone?
Yeah.
For how long?
Until he finds the one.
Yeah, until I get a girl.
Until he finds the one that makes him not want to have revenge sex.
Mm-hmm.
Yo, revenge sex is a wild. Have you ever had revenge sex?
Yes, I have.
For real?
Yeah, I have to.
Wait, this is...
He's Irish.
Holy shway.
I thought it was a white boy thing, though.
He's Irish. He's had revenge drinks.
Erickson, have you had revenge sex? Savon? Yo,
that nigga Erickson over there like
weirdo.
Yo, you saw Erickson? No, like, nah, keep me out of this, fam. I'm just here filming this shit. Like, don't ask me nothing.
Yo, all right, maybe I'm.
You guys probably had it, but didn't know you were. Yeah,
I don't know what it is.
Yeah. After you get the breakup and you just start going wild,
you're specifically fucking her for malicious reasons from your past relationship.
No. What if you fucking chicks that you want to fuck or that you always want to have to sleep with? I mean, stop sounding so vulgar. I do know how to speak.
Yeah. It's still
is
like
that revenge sex?
It's only revenge if the girl you were dating or you were with did something for the relationship to like split, and then you like,
you just all right,
now I'm out here wilding now. Yeah. Like, yeah, like nigga, fuck that. Yeah. I'm out here.
Revenge get to that me shit just out your system. Spite, like you want to get the person back or make them feel something.
Yeah, you do. Yeah, you kind of do.
Yeah, we don't flat out tell them, but we make it known that we out here.
Yeah, you might throw a little subtweet out there. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Because then it's like, oh, you so mixy. Now you out every night. Now yeah, you in every right. chick face. Now you, mm-hmm. now is,
you're right, you're I right. am.
Yep, I'm upset. Drop the shit, man.
Oh,
right,
my bad. I got
drop the 50, shit.
50,000 on my head is disrespect. Yeah.
There you go.
So offended hey. That I had to double hey. Check.
Had to double
That's
check,
kind of a
nigga.
Slow fashion, though. Yeah.
Nah, you could get the. You could get the.
You could listen to like some heavy metal in the revenge.
Yeah. 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 Got a lot hey. Of blood and it's cold. Got a lot of blood and it's cold.
I don't even fuck good enough to.
Well, no, hold on. The revenge sex is for you, it ain't for her. Yeah. Shout out to all the hey, poor women that have caught the revenge kick.
That type of honesty. That's classic on it. Listen, oh, I don't even. I ain't gonna lie.
It's like that.
This ain't even revenge. Right, this yeah. is like whatever. Fuck. Like this ain't
gonna want to revenge
fuck.
Me afterwards.
Yeah, like, yeah. yeah. I ain't getting yeah. revenge.
She's about just, to be disappointed.
That's two chicks, man. This ain't proving a point to her.
Hey, you gotta respect
them
that type
of honesty.
Them
bitches about to click up.
Like, uh-huh, you fell for it, right? I told you, girl. Disappointed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you gotta have ill dick to be like calling it like revenge sex. Like,
you gotta be going crazy.
Yeah, I don't be going crazy no more.
Going crazy no- My going crazy days are over.
What? Yeah. Think I've been tired of going crazy.
Yo, we gonna read some fan mail, man?
We have some. Are we there yet? Have we run out of everything that we. We need to talk about.
This has been the silliest podcast. Some of the
women that listen, because I retweeted that. I don't know why women listen to us. So a girl said something interesting. She said because it's like being at the barbershop. It's like women being at the barbershop. Like we don't know what y'all talk about amongst each other. So listening to the show, they feel like they're getting an insight on how we really feel, things we really be talking about.
They're getting the scoop.
So I said, oh, that was interesting.
Oh, your follower is a little different than mine. They hit me and was like, of course we love y'all. We grew up with, all the girls listening to y'all grew up with 20 brothers and 10 cousins. Y'all remind us of our family. I was like, damn, all right.
Shout out to you. We danced the Big Pimpin' too.
Right.
And what was so deep about that? We know that. We know that about women. I just am always shocked at the amount of women. It's a lot of women that listen.
Yeah, it is. It is. Like, it's dope, but it's like, I don't think this is what we... plan for. I don't know.
And let me just shout out to all the listeners and say, like, y'all are like cool fans too.
True. Yeah. So a lot of people I meet on the streets, they're pretty cool.
Yeah, y'all hit niggas with a good head nod, salute, love the podcast, mm-hmm. and keep mm-hmm. it pushing on mm-hmm. about your day. Yeah.
Boy, you know why though? I think I know for me, like one dude said some funny shit. He came up to me and he was like, yo, fam, I know you ain't with all this saying what's up shit, like you don't like niggas talking to you. But I'm a fan of the part. So I think that they listen to us and they feel like they know us personally. So they know they ain't with all this talking.
Nigga, I hate all that.
Yeah, exactly. So that's what I'm saying. They know Rory's not really a talker.
No,
really
Rory's
like
a talker. No, is Rory, he? No, Rory likes speaking.
Not really.
I've seen Rory in places where he was kind of standoffish.
I know. I'm just trying to get them to talk to him.
Oh, okay.
Oh, okay. Well, thanks, man. I'm mad doing. Polite to all our fans.
No, I
think it's
too.
Great.
I am too.
Means people like our shit. So yeah. Why would I complain about it?
Right.
Say what up. Thank you for listening. I generally mean that.
I do
awesome,
too.
Awesome, man. Awesome. Yeah.
You're a great guy, Rory.
I try to be, man.
So I want to read something real quick from one of the listeners of the show. Her name is Brand.
You just read something. How much you want to read?
I didn't read nothing.
Oh. Stop talking like you read.
No, this is. It was just funny. A girl named Brandy.
Oh, I hope I laugh.
Brandless. Liz.
Not laughing
Liz.
Yet.
So she says, hi, Maul.
Tough audience.
She says, hi, Maul. My name's Liz. I need your help. I know you give advice and shit. I have a fuck boy in my life, and he's lied so much and is so inconsistent, I don't know whether to take him seriously. But the crazy thing is, I know he loves me. You probably hear this all the time, but he do.
This is Sam from a different account.
I was about to say, yo, Rory.
This sound like Sam.
All right, Liz.
This is Sam or Sin. It's Sam or Sin, one of them.
It's not Sin.
I just don't think he knows how to be faithful due to generational factors. Anytime a girl say her man ain't faithful due to generational factors, this nigga's out there wilding. And his other experiences with women. Do I believe when he says he loves me, even with all his other bullshit? I would say I think he loves her.
Probably loves her.
Yeah, he definitely loves her.
Yeah, I think he does.
He just
loves. So yes, you should believe him.
Yeah, he just loves his other bitches too.
Yeah. He got a lot of love to give. So he has a big heart.
Yeah.
Yeah, shout out to him, man.
Shout out to him. Shout out to your fuckboy boyfriend with a big heart.
And like, you can't really overcome your genes and all the hereditary.
Yeah, like it's the genetic. Yeah. It's not his fault. Yeah, it's genetic.
Like, you don't get mad at someone if they have cancer in their family and they get cancer.
Right.
So it's like, if he's out here wilding and cheating, that's just in his blood.
It's part of his DNA. It's just part of his makeup.
Yeah. You guys are great.
You don't think that was good advice?
That's good advice.
Listen, I'm cool because if I get fired, we all get fired. We a family. We in this bitch as a team.
Yo, y'all still remember my Cash App name? Just in case.
Word. Because I'm going to be telling them every day. Hey, y'all get a daily podcast next week.
Monday through Sunday.
A daily podcast.
You want to read this? Because you know I'm not a good out loud reader. Was never part of my thing.
I'm not a good out
loud. Rory didn't like reading in front of the class?
No, I was never good at that.
Okay.
Yeah, well, that wasn't my style.
If he wasn't a Kappa,
I could do a good presentation.
Yo, if Rory wasn't a Kappa.
You could do a presentation.
Yo, I would kill the presentations. But if you make me read a book in the second row of the class, yeah.
Okay.
They laughing behind my back.
You use your finger to like follow the lines.
Chill, man. Come on.
We going to help you with that, though. I'm going to help you get out of that shit.
I want to know what was Rory's initiation. Like, he had to catch 70 mosquitoes or some dumb shit.
Bob, how did you even think of that
word?
Rory, Rory bum ass chasing behind some bugs.
Just making a catch net.
Yo, Rory had to catch 10 glowworms, the glowflies, and put them in jaws.
Hey, that nigga
I
playing,
would do that in my free time.
Hey, that nigga playing fucking Fear Factor on fucking Communipaw. Or wherever that damn school is. All right, let's see. All right, we got some fan mail. Let me just let you guys know. Boy, do I hate fan mail. All right, this one goes as follows. He says, hey.
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 All right.
What's up, man?
What's going on, bro?
Hey is so welcoming, right?
Yeah, it is. Hey.
I like Hayes. My name is Jay. I can't say my real name because my girl listens to the podcast.
I like this guy.
Swag.
Hey, Jen.
My question is for Maul
Jay
Hitch.
Jay is Rory.
You're responding to Liz?
I'm replying to Liz here.
Wait, what happened?
Never mind.
My question is for Maul Hitch.
Maul Hitch.
I'm 24 with a girl I've been with for 4 years, but I had a side chick off and on for 3 years. She has a boyfriend she's been with since she was 17. They got a kid together and all that shit. We always fuck with each other for like 6 months or until her nigga catches on.
When does that sounds about right.
When does he catch off?
Wait. No.
When does he catch off?
He said, we always fuck with each other for like 6 months or until her nigga catch her fucking with me. He done caught her twice already now, and he recently caught her in April fucking with me, so now we ain't been fucking or none of that shit. But we still talk, and we work together. So I see her every day. My problem is, I think I love the side chick, and I miss her. I thought it was just the pussy, but I actually miss talking to the side chick. I know she still like me. That's a mistake of fellas. How do you know that right. She still like you? I know she still like me, but we just ain't been like we used to. I told her how I feel, and she feels the same way, but we just not fucking with each other. So what do I do? Thank you. Love you guys.
That's for you, Mo.
That's for you, Mo.
I think first and foremost, fucking a girl you work with is dangerous.
Yeah.
That's way too close. So that's a bad idea on top. But, I mean, it sounds
like...
Well,
depending on where you work, like if they're in a car wash.
No, they're definitely they're at a bar.
That could be kinky.
Or a restaurant.
Work at a car wash.
The car wash.
Car wash people do
Joe
not
want to
fuck each other.
Between the two brushes.
Yeah,
that's
going 100%.
When have you ever seen a chick at the car wash?
All the time.
Yeah. Working there?
Working.
Oh, y'all have
register,
to get cars.
The register. No, inside the register, not outside.
Okay,
Parks
right,
he want her washing the car.
No, I don't want her at all.
She's at the register.
Wait, so women can't wash cars, what you saying, Parks?
You know, you don't see it really all the time.
No, but he want two girlfriends. That's what he gonna run.
I mean, he should.
Do y'all hear that? Do y'all know the type of arrogance that has to come from a nigga to say, y'all think girls wash their cars to a nigga that don't have a car?
Actually,
he's not even visiting the car wash.
He don't know what's happening.
No, he's just dissing chicks.
I have to take my girl to the girl's car to the car wash because she never washes her car.
Oh yeah, girls' cars be messy.
It's deep. It goes deep.
I see. You know, girls' cars do be messy.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
I want a girl a little mess in her car.
Like, kind of get you going.
Yeah, like
got a little smell to it. Her clothes been in there for a while.
No, I judge the overnight bag.
Like, whole bag.
The finer you are, the more clothes you should have in your overnight bag. Like, why chicks only come one outfit?
Yeah, because you're leaving. When shit. They come with the,
nah, no,
the 3-4 day bag, no, nah, you got to go.
We're talking about two different chicks, Rory. The chicks I'm talking about, this, that's day option.
That's day option.
Yo, the chicks with the overnight bags in the trunk, you'll let them stay. They just got it there in the tuck just because niggas will let them stay.
But it depends on what type of overnight bag she got.
You know the fucking bag that every, fit right in the little nook of the trunk.
Nah, every chick had the little Puma bag, like a bowling ball bag. Remember that little Puma bag?
I do remember
every,
that one. Yep.
I can't every laugh chick, too much.
Why? Why
because you we're filming.
Oh, okay, my bad. But back to Jonathan. Is his name Jonathan?
His name is Jay.
Jay?
He can't give you his real name.
Yeah, I mean, you sound like you want two girlfriends, man. So you're just going to have to just either just...
I think he just likes her because of the element of danger.
Yeah, but he going... He,
well, that's how you know he pussy. You just supposed to beat homeboy up. Like, you still letting her go home and cuddling up at night with this nigga.
He said,
well,
clearly, he got to beat up this caught, side first of all, the other boyfriend caught them twice. Fucking around twice.
He's a little soft.
Yeah,
pause.
I kind of want to talk to the...
Homie, that, Jay, that's your girl, man.
Yeah, that's a fact.
That's your girlfriend, too. Yeah. Tell her to stop acting up at work.
Yeah,
man.
He's
smack on the back of her ass, man. Like, listen, stop
wait,
acting
no,
up.
Wait, no, no, no. Yeah, now that y'all, the more y'all talk, the more I think Jay is a little pussy.
No.
He got caught twice.
Well, that's true. They're both pussy.
But he's still trying to fuck with her. He ain't pussy.
No, yeah, he ain't. He worked with her.
Yeah, he needs to put some pressure on her.
He worked with her.
Yeah, but he said she acting funny. He's still trying to, he asking me, like, yo, what's up with her?
She put some pressure on the boyfriend. The boyfriend caught them twice.
The boyfriend came to the job.
For sure.
Yeah, and now homeboy.
You think he got his car washed?
Homeboy
there?
Emailing us
from underneath the desk.
Jay, like, man, yo. Get up.
Yeah, Jay, get up from under that desk, man. There, you alright, man? Don't worry about
you're
it.
You fine.
Say, go power wash that car in peace.
Plenty of fish in the sea.
Right. You got another one, Rory?
Yeah, we got one. Dating a 25-year-old female virgin.
Dating a 25-year-old female.
That is the subject.
Wow.
All right, guys.
All right.
She says, I know. But I am not ugly. Just a virgin.
Yeah, that's objective.
I live in the Los Angeles area, born and raised.
She ain't
and
ugly.
Get asked out on dates by many regulars, actors, ballers, etc.
Ballers.
What is etc.?
Mad niggas. Et cetera.
Et cetera is drug dealers, scammers.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
A few niggas.
All of them niggas is et cetera.
But a few car niggas in et cetera people. Beat.
Yeah. A like, few et cetera beat.
Once niggas hit you with et cetera, nah, they ain't just et cetera.
Mm-hmm. Right, she's a fine. Virgin, she said.
Debatable. However, I have not found a guy that I genuinely like or who I want to have sex with. Great personality, great paying job, and everything. My question is, being a 25-year-old virgin a bad thing? Turn on, turn off? Should I just have sex with like two guys or so before I find someone special? Just so he would know I have experience?
Do you remember the...
more than two.
The virgin prostitute we met one time on tour?
I'm sorry, the what?
Listen, man.
That was the funniest thing I've ever experienced in my life.
The virgin prostitute.
She said that she sells like her armpits and feet for dudes to smell.
I do remember that.
I've never laughed
at all. Can you say what location this would be in so I know not to
Denver,
ever go
Colorado.
Near there? Oh, I like Denver.
And I was really
I
high because
I love
weed
Denver.
Is there.
Denver's great.
It's good and legal.
Denver is super,
I
super
laughed
great.
Harder than I ever laughed in my entire life. Because they was just chilling for a long time. You would think that they're virgins. But then
so are you suggesting this woman should maybe sell her armpit hair in the meantime?
Yeah.
I love Denver until you wake up there on a Sunday. Then you ain't really going to like it. The whole city put on a Denver Bronco jersey.
Yeah, orange too.
Together.
That's not
hoodies, hats. You feel like you can't say nothing about the Giants and nobody. They will right. Fuck you up in Denver.
Yeah.
So what was your advice, Rory, that she should fuck a whole bunch of guys?
She should definitely go out and get some experience before she finds a guy she likes.
Yeah, what did Drake call it? Practice?
Yes, she could use some practice.
Yo,
I'm not saying go out there and just find
some
dude.
Wild shit to chicks in very poetic, lovey ways.
It's the melodies, and they love it. They sing right along to it.
That nigga said all them niggas was just practice.
Mm-hmm. And the girls were like, he right. They was practice. I've been practicing to meet you. Drake be sitting there like, yeah. You done know.
You done know.
Drake definitely hit bitches with the you done know.
Maul, are you dating a virgin?
Now, like in my car.
Yeah, like if you ran into a girl you liked and she was a virgin. Would you be into that?
Mal's a fucking virgin. Fuck out of here, nigga.
Mal's not a virgin. I don't think I could do it.
Yeah, I know you're not a virgin. You got up and started ironing.
Yo, Joe loved to take that. This nigga be lying his ass off.
You was ironing, but we're not gonna get it.
I was not, man.
Well, would you fuck the virgin or not?
I don't know that. No, nigga,
I'm not saying her. Just in general.
Nah, it's trash now. It's over. Yeah,
have you ever fucked a virgin?
Yeah,
I have. It's trash.
It's horrible.
I never did it. It's really
bad.
It's bad.
You're not missing anything.
Yeah, yeah. Nah.
That shit was cool in '96.
Yeah.
Like when Reasonable Doubt was out.
Yeah, now it's kind of like,
no way.
Can I live? And
but to answer her question, she should.
Regrets?
Get some type of, you know.
Yeah, find a guy that you find safe and that you like.
Get some sexual experiences.
And go fuck.
Yeah.
You're 25.
Yeah. Live a little.
Got any more fan mail?
I think that's enough for today.
Nigga, Rory hung up on you. Rory hung up on you in real life. I think that's enough for the day.
No, Rory still thinks Sam sent that email.
He's still scared. He don't want to answer
no more.
He's
sitting there tight. He's ready to go have revenge sex.
They keep trying to get me for my soul. Thankful for the women that I know.
We got sleepers. So I'm going to play an old record. Not as old as my H-Town record. Fuck, y'all got the giggles today?
Fuck, play your H-Town record again.
That was a great record.
It is a great record.
But I'm not playing it. Yo, you niggas love putting your little eyes on my computer. Got a whole computer in front of you. Fuck out of here.
You're playing a sleeper.
Now, I'm going to play a song called Pull Up featuring Jacquees by a young lady named Summerella.
That was not so brand new music from Summer called Pull Up. It's a little old, came out in 2016, but I love that record. Shout out to her.
I liked it too.
Thanks, Rory. Appreciate that, buddy.
No problem. All right, I'm going to play Malaya featuring... Dirty Laundry. Got yours yet, Mo?
Speaking of dirty laundry, I need to do laundry. Thanks, Rory. You're so helpful, man. I'll tell you.
For reminding you about doing your laundry?
Yeah, man.
The basket just wasn't piling up. It wasn't enough of a reminder.
Black people, man, we just look at shit and just...
You do your own laundry or you just drop it off at the spot?
No, I do my own laundry.
Yeah, me too. It's cathartic.
Same with me.
Therapeutic for me.
Yeah.
I ain't done laundry in years.
You just got it like that. My bad, bro.
It's $30.
It'll only be like $5 if you do it yourself, though.
Well, you no, I either? Got the machine in my crib now. I used to not.
I got 4 washing machines. I ain't doing none of that shit. I like when they fold it, make it smell nice. For $30, I'll take it.
This is Jane Hancock, 647.
Yeah, now that you say that, you're sweating.
I'm always on to something new. I'm hardly ever satisfied. Sometimes it's hard for me to choose. Will I be wrong? Will I be right? Why is it always for me to flip on you? I wouldn't wait for you to flip on me. I don't know why I talk to you. you like that, damn. But I can't let go, you got the soul on me. Why? Usually I'm a thug, but when it comes to love, I just run and hide. I could never make my mind up. I said from day one, I hope that you can read me, baby. I wrote all my pages just for you. And this ain't no fairy tale, babe. The future is scary as hell, baby. But it's alright.
But it's alright.
Cause as long as I'm with you, everything is cool. I don't get too deep, cause every time we lose, that's why I don't think, I just only do. Fuck your mind, color in the lines. Never lie, before I lie, I'll be quiet, you want all my time. But I need me, sometimes more by myself. I'm not perfect, I'm not perfect. Got some issues, I can't help, no. I put in the air, baby. Yes, I share, baby. You can never say I played you, I wasn't clear, baby. I ain't the one to text you all day, so kill it. I ain't the one to show everybody my business. I don't need to go through your messages, that's too much. You wanna go through my needs, baby, so back that up. I got feelings, you got feelings, and we feel it. When we vibe, chemistry is to the ceiling. Sometimes I fight, cause my mouth can't get it gripping. You the only thing that could tame me to a kitten.
You wanna tame me, yeah. But it's alright.
Cause as long as I'm with you,
everything is cool.
I don't get too deep, cause every time we lose, that's why I don't think, I just only do.
I just wanna do wanna feel
what I feel.
Got a lot of crazy thoughts and feelings in my heart for you.
I don't wanna run around and take a while.
There's no direction, fuck them out. Let me get lost with you.
As long as I'm with you, everything is cool. I don't get too deep, cause every time we lose,
yeah.
That's why I don't think, I just only do what I feel.
Got a lot of crazy
thoughts and feelings in my heart for you. I don't wanna run around and take a walk with you. No direction, fuck a map, let me get lost with you.
Jane Hancock, 647.
That shit was hard.
Yeah, good record.
Who sang that song?
Jane Hancock. Pause.
It's a dope name, dope song.
Yeah.
I'm reading a billboard.
Good round of sleepers I'm reading this week, guys.
Oh, yeah, thank you, Rory, man.
No, thank you. I think we all showed out pretty well.
I'm reading an article on Billboard that says Hollywood seeking a foothold in $314 million podcast industry. I'm telling y'all where it is because I'm not going to read it to y'all. We are ending this podcast, but I like articles like this, and I'm going to read it.
And we're going to Hollywood.
I saw,
we're going to Hollywood.
You know that iHeart, that big-ass iHeart Media billboard on your way to the Bronx?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They have right below it now. And podcast too.
Oh yeah, I saw that on the way back.
Yeah.
In the Bronx, yeah. That's cool. Our shit on 42nd.
No, you're missing. Shit, you're missing.
42nd and 8th.
No, I was suggesting that podcasts are just growing so big now that iHeart is making it a priority.
All right, I understand that. Yeah. I was telling people where the billboard is, like it's on 42nd Street.
Yeah.
It's not in the Bronx.
Talk that shit. Has your hat been in the picture the whole time?
Yes.
Branding.
Why? I'm just curious. Parks? I mean, what's up? What's going on?
It's cool, man. It's a cool hat.
Got some ribbon shit going on.
Yeah, like the little Michael Jackson silk shit around.
No, wait till you see the outfit that hat went
with. It matches with.
It got some beads.
I want to know.
Oh my god.
Does it have like flowy leather?
No, it's some short,
like tassels?
Short, very fitted, form fitting leather with a very tight black T-shirt with some Durangos.
How come you wear the whole fit?
Durangos.
With some really tight spandexy jeans.
Cowboy boots?
Yeah. Yeah, it was a vibe, though.
It's a vibe.
It was a vibe, though.
Is there more silk?
You got to end it. Yeah, it was a vibe, though.
The silk and the beads really bring it all together. I hope the beads come through on the camera.
And while we say that, let me end by saying Maul is really upset that he couldn't find the silk satin Ralph Lauren Yankee bomber jacket that sold out before he could find his raffle ticket.
Yeah, I know. Because all these damn hype beasts, man, this shit is crazy. You can't get nothing no more. Like, these hype beasts with these bots and these apps, as soon as they press some shit, it's like sold out. Come on, man.
You got to get more than one raffle.
I don't have I don't do raffles, Joe.
Why not?
Oh, then definitely. Yeah, so you're not getting a jacket.
Fuck that. You can wait outside for 3 days.
Yeah, you could just get someone to make one for you. It's just a Yankee jacket.
Somebody did make it for me. Ralph Lauren.
Oh, he did?
He just sold out.
How long you be waiting in line at Supreme?
I don't wait in line at Supreme.
How you be getting your Supreme?
I know one of the little hype beasts niggas that be selling the shit.
So you can't diss hype beasts and use them.
No, but it's like they.
No, you can.
You have no choice. Definitely can. I have no choice. That's what I'm trying to say. It's like,
they
damn.
They ain't hold you down on the Ralph Yankee?
I got to ask around. I know somebody got it. But it's like, I'm going to have to pay that, you know what I mean, that extra. It's like
tax.
Yeah, like, come on, man.
The hype beast
tax. Yeah.
That shit is trash.
You have to get a different fit.
Because it's always niggas that don't know how to dress that buy 20 of them shit.
Does it come with a fitted?
It's a hat that comes with it that I wanted too, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Is it I'll find, too? Yo, you give me another year of, put a third year of podcast in your contract. I'll find a jacket.
It'll be vintage by that point. So that's actually nice. That's
talking
nice
of him about, to say that.
He reading that Billboard Hollywood report. Trying to extort motherfuckers. I see what's going on here.
It's crazy. Joe's the label now. That's crazy.
We ain't even get no gunshots.
You can't sell us bullshit. We know the prices.
We trash on Saturdays.
Not because you ain't shoot no guns.
Too many gunshots on Saturdays.
Yeah, lick off, man. Fuck it. Pause.
All right. Bye.